from Florida, two of the top passers in college football. It might take an air traffic controller to call today's game. What are your thoughts?
Well, you're right. 1,000 yards in total offense last year in Knoxville. Tony Robinson got close to 400 yards against UCLA passing the ball. Against Auburn, he threw 4 touchdown passes. Pat Dye at Auburn says Tony Robinson's the best quarterback in the country. Johnny Majors at Tennessee says Tony Robinson's the best quarterback in the country. So it's going to be exciting to watch that young man perform. He's a senior, but the Gators got a sophomore named Kerwin Bell, and he knows how to play that quarterback position also.
Well, now, as far as the Air Force is concerned, we know about that. What about the infantry?
Well, the infantry is going to be very important. That Florida rushing game has come together the last couple of ball games. If the Gators can control the ball on the ground, move down the field, they can eat up the clock and keep Tony Robinson on the bench. Now, Tennessee is last in the SEC in rushing defense. They're last in the SEC in scoring defense. So the Gators have a chance to kill that clock with a rushing game. So I think they might run first and pass second.
Defensively now, Florida's defense has been the magnificent 11, not allowing a point in the past 6 quarters.
Oh, what a performance by that Gator defense. You know, to get a big goose egg is incredible, especially when you're playing at LSU or a team like at Mississippi State. That Gator defense has been awesome, and they need to show up this afternoon.
Well, we're looking forward to it. We'll be back with a kickoff and all the action right after these messages.
Fighting Gator Football is brought to you by Atlantic Bank, the best bank around. By Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Florida, we hear you and we're working on the answers. By the Florida Citrus Growers, Orange Juice Smart for drinking Florida orange juice. By Dairy Farmers Incorporated, producers of real Florida fresh milk. By Eastern Airlines, they earn their wings every day. By Farm Credit Service of Florida. Also by your Florida and South Georgia Ford dealers, home of America's best built cars and trucks. By Gatorade Thirst Quencher. Gatorade is thirsty for that deep down body thirst. By Gator Bait, Florida's number one independent sports weekly. By Likes Meats, quality meat products for your family. By Scotty's, serving Florida with over 115 convenient locations. By Sonny's Real Pit Barbecue. For barbecue at its best, it's Sonny's Real Pit Barbecue, with locations throughout Florida and the Southeast. And by Whirlpool. See the yellow pages for the authorized Whirlpool heating and cooling dealer nearest you.
You can look out and see a sea of orange at Florida Field in Gainesville as the Volunteers invade the Gatorland to take on the Fighting Gators today. Weather at kickoff, 84 degrees, wind from the northwest at 10, and the temperature on the turf, Jim Yarbrough, 113 degrees. The Gators, 3-0-1, ranked 7th in the nation, beat Miami, tied Rutgers, beat Mississippi State, and beat LSU.
You know, they describe Tennessee's colors as burnt orange, and they're burned by that heat out there this afternoon. As we look at Tennessee's record, Jim Gallagher,
2-0-1, tied with UCLA, defeated Auburn, and defeated Wake Forest. So a tough game in store for this afternoon. What about that 113 degree temperature?
Well, it's going to affect, I think, the spirit of the kids maybe in the beginning of the game, because they realize all their energy is going to be taxed during the next 4 quarters, so they're going to save a lot of that emotion in hopes of being able to get more physical energy later in the game. So it might drain the spirit a little bit, but the kids are going to perform physically all afternoon on both sides, and maybe Florida has an advantage because of the heat and being the home field.
Florida won the toss and will receive, and I would have to agree with that assessment. And you can see there's a great crowd on hand this afternoon. It's been a tough ticket all week long as we get ready for the kickoff. And kicking off for the Volunteers of the University of Tennessee will be Carlos Reves. And, of course, his older brother kicks for the Miami Dolphins, has come on very strong this year to kick off for the Dolphins and to become their place kicker. There you're looking at Ricky Natiel, the great kick returner for the University of Florida. And awaiting the kickoff in just a few moments, across the way, Johnny Majors, head coach at Tennessee. What a great record he has had as a coach, won the national championship in 76 with Pitt. Reves moves to the football, boots it high. It'll be taken by Natiel about 2 yards deep. He's at the 5, he's at the 10, cuts off, and he's across the 15 down at the 17-yard line. A nice return for this young man from Newberry, Florida. Kerwin Bell, there he is, statistically 67, 103, 960 yards, percent 65, 10 touchdowns, and only 4 interceptions. 63201 from Day, Florida. Population 250. Offensively for the Gators, it'll be Neil Anderson, John L. Williams, Ricky Natiel, Ray McDonald, and Walter Odom in the skill positions. Getting ready for the snap now on the 17-yard line, first and 10. And the give-off goes to the tailback, and that would be Neil Anderson, and gets a couple of tough yards, brought down by Fred Bennett and by Dale Jones for the Tennessee Vols.
Well, we mentioned at the outset, Tennessee's had problems stopping the running game.
Kimbrough, Scott, Ziegler, Brown, Miller, Hovannik, and Jones for Tennessee defensively, along with Brown, Sims, Davis, and Peppers. And they'll be the deep people for the Volunteers. On second down and 8 from the 19-yard line, the Gators. Kerwin Bell looks to throw. He's got his man, John L. Williams, coming out of the backfield on the far side. Bounced out of bounds after picking up the first down at about the 28-yard line by Chris White, the free safety for Tennessee. John L. has had just a fine all-purpose back, caught 20 balls for 167 yards.
A new formation there early in the ball game. The Gators come with 3 wide outs. The tight end's not in the ball game. Let's see if that happens again here. Yes, 3 wide, no. They got the tight end back in the game right now.
Well, they've got a flanker and a wide out, and they go with the I formation on first down from the 28-yard line. The give-off goes to Neil Anderson. Anderson hits it off the right side for a couple to about the 30, maybe across to the 31-yard line before he's brought down by the ball defense. Inside linebacker Darren Miller, number 45, made the hit on Neil. Neil, 90 carries, 397 yards, averaging 4.4 per carry, 2 touchdowns, longest run, 61 yards. He is the all-time leading rusher in Florida history. Second and a call it 8 right now from the 30-yard line as Kerwin Bell looks. Quick one out to John L. Williams. He's at the 35. He's across the 40. He's across the 45-yard line and knocked out of bounds in front of the Florida bench at the 48 by the outside linebacker, it looked like, on that one. And that would be Darren Miller making the hit along with Chris White.
Dale Jones, number 54, the outside linebacker, drops straight back instead of covering that flat. Kerwin has the poise to look for John L. Williams, his favorite receiver. John L. has plenty of room out there because the linebacker's not in that zone.
Picks up 18 on that one. It goes to the 48-yard line where it will be first down for the Gators. They've got wide side to the right. And out of your screen, Ray McDonald would be split, as Jim pointed out a little while ago. The give off goes to John L. Williams. He goes to the 47-yard line. And Kerry Ziegler brings him down, the inside linebacker. He's a sophomore from Miami, Florida, went to Palmetto High School.
Another new formation. That time the Gators come out with 2 tight ends. So we've seen 3 wide outs, we've seen 2 tight ends, and we've seen their standard pro set.
Second down and 5 on the 47 of Tennessee as Florida moves into Volunteer territory. Tennessee going with the 3 down linemen. Kerwin Bell taking a look. Looks like he's went with an audible. And the pitch goes to Neil Anderson, cuts off the right side, and Tennessee sniffed that one out at the 46-yard line. And Jeff Zimmerman, a good block on that one. Kerry Ziegler brings him down. Again, the sophomore from Miami Palmetto. There's a Florida player, Jim, as you very well know, with Tennessee, with athletic director Doug Dickey, former head coach and player at Florida. His son Darryl is the backup quarterback behind Tony Robinson. And then, of course, the fine kicker, Reves, who is from Miami. Richard Brown, their middle guard, is from Riviera Beach. And Kerry Ziegler, the inside linebacker, is from Miami.
2 tight ends.
Third down and 4. As Kerwin Bell looks, pops out to John L. Williams. John L. cuts in and hits down at the 45-yard line. So he is going to be short of the first down. And making the hit for the Volunteers, it would be Darren Miller and Dale Jones.
Great reaction by Tennessee on the screen pass. Florida's moved the ball well here in the first quarter. They're across the 50-yard line. You got an All-American kicker coming out, Ray Criswell, and the Gators are hoping they can pin Tennessee deep in their own territory and make Tony Robinson go 90 or 85 yards to get some points on the board.
We've got a player down on the field, and we'll be back with more action from Florida Field, but right now we'll take time out for these messages. First first and 10 from the 7-yard line. A 38-yard punt by Ray Criswell, down by Scott Marshall of the Gators at the 7-yard line. A great play by special teams, and the give off inside for Tennessee as they carry up to about the 10-yard line, as they go right across the 10 for about a 3.5-yard pickup on that play. They're going to call it down at the 11-yard line, so it'll be second down, and call it 6 yards to go. Panuska, Howard, Swanson, McGee, and Smith, the starters for Tennessee. Tony Robinson, the fine quarterback, a senior from Tallahassee, Florida, out of Leon High School. I formation. Giveoff goes to the tailback, and he goes over the right side, and it looks like he's got the first down at the 20-yard line. That would be Keith Davis, the ball carrier, a freshman from Nashville. Brought down by Scott Armstrong, the junior from Ocala, Florida. Miller, Mitz, Pennington, Roth, Armstrong, Williams, and Alonzo Johnson defensively for Florida. The deep people, Stacy Knight, Adrian White, and Jarvis Williams. First and 10 on the 20-yard line for the Vols of Tennessee. Robinson, the great thrower for the Volunteers. Split backfield behind the young man from Tallahassee. Looks out in the flat, and he's got his man, number 87, at the 25-yard line, Joey Klinkscales. The wide out on the right side, he goes down at the 25, so they pick up 5 yards and bring him down, Curtis Stacy, for the University of Florida.
They felt like Curtis Stacy was giving Joey Klinkscales a little too much room there, so Tony Robinson just audibled off, picked up a quick 5 yards.
He's part of that big air attack at Tennessee. It'll be second down 5 on the 25 for the Volunteers. They're on the near side hash mark. They've got a slot to the left side. Robinson looks to throw. A quick one out there. Incomplete. Intended for Keith Davis. A little swing pass. But a little over his head. Goes as incomplete. And Leon Pennington, the good pressure man for the University of Florida defensive unit.
Nice job by Pennington. He had that pass covered. Even if Davis had caught it, he would have been hit immediately by Leon Pennington.
So that'll bring up third down. Still 5 at the 25-yard line. Tennessee deep in their own territory. Criswell's punt, and a great job by special teams, sent him way back to the 7-yard line.
Clifford Charlton comes in to give some pressure.
Boy, is he tough.
And he's offside.
7 seconds left to play in the first period. Still no score in the football game. Illegal procedure. It's going to go against Tennessee, so they're going to mark it off back to the 20.
Well, that's a break for the Gators. It looked like Clifford Charlton might have got anxious there, but he saw a lineman move, so he jumped across the line of scrimmage. Automatic penalty against the Volunteers.
No score in the football game, bringing together two very explosive offenses.
Big third down. Let's watch the pressure from the outside linebackers. Keep an eye on 93 Alonzo Johnson, and on the other side, 56 Clifford Charlton. Let's see what they can do.
Here's Tony Robinson, the great thrower for Tennessee, with a lone setback. Waiting for the snap. And now he has called time. He looked over at that Gator defense and saw something that he didn't like.
Well, what he saw was Jarvis Williams, the cornerback, threatening the blitz. You don't see a cornerback line up very often in a blitz situation.
We'll be back, but first, these messages. Down and 10. Ball on the 20. Tennessee is in possession deep in their own territory.
And the Gators have that fifth defensive back in there. Dwayne Glover, number 33, comes in. And Jarvis Williams moves up near that line of scrimmage and threatened Tony Robinson there. And he wasn't sure what was going to happen, so he wisely called a timeout.
9 minutes, 57 seconds to play in the first quarter. No score between the Gators and the Vols. The Vols 2-0-1, 1-0 in the SEC. The Gators 3-0-1, 2-0 in the SEC. Robinson waits for the snap with a lone setback. Again, looks at Florida. Taking a long time. Four down linemen, they're in the nickel. Robinson comes up the middle. Robinson gets away from one man, gets away from another, and gets to the 40-yard line as he picks up the first down. Brought down by Curtis Stacy and Scott Armstrong.
That was not an accident. That was a designed play. The quarterback draws in the playbook. When you got a runner like Tony Robinson, one step drop. Look at the linebacker. Watch Armstrong. He's trying to get in pass coverage. Tony Robinson's running at him before he realizes it's a run. That was a well-executed quarterback draw. Adrian White coming up to make the tackle.
20-yard gain for Tony Robinson. First and 10 on the 40. The Tennessee Volunteers in possession of the football. Florida now with the three-down lineman going back to the 3-4. Robinson dropping back to throw. He's got time being chased over in the corner. Unloads, and it is incomplete. Let's go down to the sideline now to John Nugent.
Jim, at noontime, the Gator trainers were down here on the field taking the turf temperature. It was 116 degrees. The Gators are used to it. How Tennessee holds up remains to be seen.
Well, thanks very much for that report from the sideline, John. I don't envy you being out in the elements, as it were, today.
That's true. We were down there earlier, and it is hot.
Second and 10 on the 40-yard line for the Vols of Tennessee. The give-off on the draw play goes to the fullback, and that's Sam Henderson. He goes straight up the middle and gets yardage to the 45-yard line, brought down by Jeff Ross, freshman from Seminole, Florida, and Leon Pennington, the inside linebacker, the big senior from Fort Lauderdale.
Well, it's a real chess match here in the first quarter. The Gators are doing some jumping around on defense. Tony Robinson is making some audible calls. So far, Tennessee's been able to figure out that Gator defense. Let's see what happens on this third down.
And five from the 45-yard line for Tennessee. They're still on their side of the 50. Dropping back and looking is Tony Robinson. He goes long, and it is complete into Gator territory. A big hit put on the wide receiver, and that would be
Eric Swanson, I think.
Number 27, Eric Swanson, the senior from California. Adrian White brings him down, the junior from Oak Park.
It's tough to pick up these Tennessee numbers from the height we are, but Swanson gets down across the middle. Good protection by that Tennessee offensive line. The Gators are expecting to have to bend today when you face a talent like Tony Robinson, but they don't want to break and give up the points.
First and 10 on the 38-yard line of Florida for the Vols of Tennessee. Tony Robinson being pressured, being chased, scrambles out and comes out of bounds here on the near side, way behind the line of scrimmage as he steps out at the 46-yard line. Jeff Roth, the big freshman from Seminole, Florida, the guy who chased him out. By the way, Jim and I will be picking our selection of the Mid-State Federal Player of the Game in the fourth quarter. Last week, Clifford Charlton, what a great game he had at Baton Rouge. Second down. Coming up, 17 yards to go on the 46-yard line for Tennessee. A split backfield now behind Tony Robinson. Great end zone shot. You can see the lineup there. The give off on the draw goes to the fullback. He rips off the left side and goes to the 36-yard line before he's brought down. Sam Henderson on the carry. Ricky Knight, the sophomore from Gainesville, makes the hit.
Nice blocking by the Tennessee offensive guard and fullback. Watch him block the inside linebackers. That's what makes this play go. Sam Henderson gets a big gain because of the blocks on the inside linebackers on that well-designed draw.
Third down, 7. Ball on the 36-yard line for the Vols of Tennessee. Florida with the three-down linemen. Linebackers right in the gaps. Robinson throws out in the flat, and he is hit and stays on his feet and fights forward across the 35 to the 34-yard line. Keith Davis, the receiver, in the backfield. Alonzo Johnson, the hitman for the Gators of Florida.
Jarvis Williams puts on a big hit, but he wasn't able to wrap Keith Davis up. Keith Davis did a fine job of spinning loose and continuing down the field.
We're going to see the field goal attempt come from the 41-yard line, so it'll be a 51-yard attempt. And Reyes is perfect in the extra point category and perfect in the field goal category at 85 for 29 points. A 51-yard attempt for Reyes. Boots it. And it is off to the side. No good. So the Gators take over the football.
Bend but don't break. You're going to see that all afternoon in terms of the Gators' defensive philosophy.
Well, they sure didn't break that time, and the kick was off to the side, and so the offense gets the football back.
And again, Ray Criswell punts. Tennessee starts inside their own 10-yard line. They have some success, but not enough success to go 90 yards and get points. That's that bend but don't break philosophy.
It's a good one. 6 minutes, 37 seconds to play. First quarter, no score. First and 10 at the 34 for the Gators. As you see in the end zone shot, Neil Anderson dots the eye as Kerwin Bell chance to signals. Bell looking, throws, incomplete. A little short to John L. Williams coming out of the backfield.
Looked like that ball slipped out of Kerwin's hand. John L. Williams didn't have a chance.
As warm as it is down there, you know there's got to be a lot of sweaty palms, and I'm sure that's going to happen a lot this afternoon.
That's exactly right. That's probably what happened. He probably had some moisture on his hands, and the ball just slipped.
Second down, 10 at the 34-yard line for the Gators. 26 touchdown passes for this guy in his college career. And what a fine young man he is. Neil Anderson takes the pitch, turns the field, and fights across the 40 to the 41-yard line. Still in his own territory. The senior from Graceville, Florida. Florida's all-time leading rusher, Darren Miller. Sophomore inside linebacker makes the hit along with Rich Cooper.
Good field position for the Gators. Obviously, they're just outside their own 40-yard line.
Third down, 3, and the ball on the 46-yard line. High formation. The up back, John L. Williams. The pitch to Neil Anderson. Turning on the left side, got the first down in front of the Tennessee bench right at the 45.
You know, Tennessee is last in the SEC in terms of stopping the rush, but what a job they did against Auburn. They just killed Bo Jackson and the War Eagle in Knoxville a couple of weeks ago.
12 career 100-yard rushing games for Neil Anderson, but credit Jeff Zimmerman and Walter Odom with some good blocking on that last play. You're looking at Galen Hall, the head coach at the University of Florida. Done a superb job.
Undefeated, Galen Hall.
First and 10 at the 45. Looks to throw. Kerwin Bell looks, and it is incomplete. Intended for Ray McDonald running a post, but good coverage there by Tennessee. He was trying to thread the needle a little bit there. Kerry Ziegler, the sophomore inside linebacker, good defensive play for Tennessee. Here it is again.
Kerwin Bell has plenty of time. That young offensive line gives him tremendous protection. Looking for Ray McDonald and Kelly Ziegler reacting just at the last second. A nice reaction by Kelly Ziegler, number 49 for the Volunteers.
Second and 10 at the 45-yard line for the Gators. I formation again with receivers left and right. And Kerwin Bell looking to throw, being pressured, hits, unloads it, and it is complete to Odom, the tight end at the 48-yard line. And what a great grab by this young man who's come on so strong this season. He's caught 12 balls for 181 yards.
Kerwin's going to get some pressure up the middle. He's forced to get out of the pocket. Nice job by number 49 again for Tennessee. Kelly Ziegler putting the pressure on. Walters available. He knows Kerwin's in trouble. They don't pick up much. Big third down for the Gators.
There's the Tennessee bench. 5 minutes and 30 seconds to play in the first quarter. No score in the ball game. It's third down, 8 on the 47 for Florida. They're on their side of the midfield stripe. Nice shot up. Walter Odom, the junior tight end from Miami American High School. A lone setback now behind Kerwin Bell. John L. Williams. And Kerwin Bell going long. He's got it. White makes the hit for the Tennessee Volunteer defense. Neil, the junior from Okeechobee, Florida, a nice catch.
You talk about depth. The Gators have great depth at the wide receiver position. Another new formation. They got four wide receivers in the game. Frankie Neal splits that deep zone, comes back to the football. Kerwin picks him out. Nice play for the Gators. They continue to move the ball in this series.
First and 10 at the 26-yard line, and that was a 28-yarder. The give goes to Neil Anderson, but he is drilled by Dale Jones, the junior outside linebacker for Tennessee.
Dale Jones on a quick read there, blitzing through where the guard was pulling. The guard is gone. Dale Jones reads the guard pull, and he's sitting in the backfield. That could have caused a fumble. That type of play can cause a fumble very easily.
Neil Anderson doesn't fumble very often. He's got great hands and a great awareness of where he is and what he's doing on the football field. 4:20 to play first quarter. No score. It's second and 12 on the 28-yard line. And Kerwin Bell looks. He's got his man, Jonnell Williams, out in the flat. And Williams wrestled out of bounds at the 21-yard line by Tommy Sims, a senior strong safety for Tennessee.
And Kelly Ziegler over there again, number 49. What a fine game he's playing for Tennessee from his linebacker position. That's a favorite play for the Florida Gators. Jonnell Williams is always available in the flat. That kind of play will keep an offense moving.
There he is. Palatka, Florida, Palatka High School. Played for a great Gator over there, Bobby Lyle. Third and five at the 21-yard line, waiting for the snap now, is Kerwin Bell. He's going to go to the air, throws, and it is intercepted by Tennessee. He's at the 10, the 15, run out of bounds. On the far side at the 23-yard line, Chris White, a senior free safety, makes the interception. Jimmy Davis makes the tackle for Florida.
I think perhaps Neil Anderson runs the wrong route here. Kerwin expects him to cut inside. Neil goes down the sideline. You see Neil Anderson right there. I think Kerwin was expecting him to go for the post, but he wasn't there, and it was picked off by Tennessee.
Well, White's an excellent player. He's one of the leading interceptors in the nation, and he's got a great nose for the ball. The return was for 15 yards. It's first and 10 on the 23-yard line. Tony Robinson goes to work at quarterback and pitches to Keith Davis coming in the near side, and the Florida defense really takes him down as he comes to the 22-yard line. Right behind the line of scrimmage, loses a yard. Ron Moten, the first guy to greet him there for the University of Florida.
You know, this Keith Davis is a freshman. He's averaging a little bit more rushing per game than Jonnell Williams is for the Gators. So he's a good back, and they're going to use him a lot. So the Gators just can't tee off on Tony Robinson's passing game.
3 minutes, 30 seconds to play first quarter. No score. Second and 10 on the 23-yard line now for Tennessee's Vols. A split backfield behind Tony Robinson, the quarterback from Tallahassee, Florida. Being blitzed, and he pops it out there quickly to Keith Davis coming out of the backfield. And Davis turns upfield and gets across the 30 to the 31-yard line. So he turns that into a good gainer as we go to the sideline for John Nugent.
Jim, last defensive series, Curtis Stacy sprained his left knee. The knee is wrapped in ice right now. Trainers don't know if and when he'll be back in this ball game.
Knight Burnell Brown on the tackle. That's not good news for Florida.
Curtis Stacy's a fine player. Ricky Mulberry knows how to play that cornerback position, though, and let's see if Tennessee might pick on him later in the ballgame.
Third and one at the 32 for the Volunteers. Now they go with a full house backfield, and the give off goes to the fullback straight up the middle, Sam Henderson, and he goes over the top. Let's see if he's got the first down. Mulberry and Pennington greet him for Florida. Pennington, the senior from Fort Lauderdale, and Mulberry, a sophomore from Palatka.
Now both teams are having some success moving up and down and down the field, but they can't get in the end zone or get that field goal right now. Both defenses doing a nice job against the other team's offense.
So the Tennessee Volunteers pick up the first down at the 32-yard line. A little over 2 minutes to play in the first quarter. Still no score. Florida with the four down linemen and looking to throw as Robinson. He does, and it's complete. The quick look in to the 46-yard line, brought down by Adrian White. And that was Eric Swanson.
Adrian White does a nice job at the safety. Look at Tony Robinson. Look to the right, then come back to his left. He might have done that intentionally. Adrian White has plenty of speed at that safety position. He gets over there in a hurry.
Gain of 13 yards. It'll be first and 10 on the 46 for the Vols. They're still on their side of the 50. The pitch going to the fullback, coming to the near side, and that would be Sam Henderson. And Henderson, as he cuts back, is brought down. And it looks like he may have the first down. Adrian White makes the hit for Florida. Davis in 85, 42 for 223, averaging a little over 5 yards per carry, and he has gotten into the end zone once. They're bringing the chain gang across to measure it with a minute 24 to play here at Florida Field in Gainesville. An excellent matchup as these two teams, Jim, kind of feel each other out like a couple of big heavyweight fighters in this first quarter.
And the clock continues to tick. We're down to about a minute 24 left in the first quarter and no score. Last year, these teams had scored left and right, 50-yard pass, 40-yard draw, 30-yard pass. It just went back and forth in terms of getting on the scoreboard. They're moving the ball, but they're not getting the points like they did last year.
First and 10 for the Vols at the 43 of Florida as the Gators' defense digs in. Tony Robinson, the throw, goes out in the flat. It is complete but drilled right at the 40-yard line as he catches the football as the wide receiver for Tennessee, Joey Klinkscales. Ricky Knight and Jarvis Williams bring him down for Florida. Second down, 7, ball at the 40-yard line. Less than a minute to play in the first quarter. Here come the Vols. Tony Robinson, 6 for 8 for 50 yards this afternoon. Volunteers in the eye with a slot. On the reverse, the give off comes to the wing back, and that was sniffed out by the Florida defense right at the 40-yard line. Bringing the wing back down, Eric Swanson, was Ron Moten and Scott Armstrong.
Nice job by the linebackers. Armstrong stays home. Ron Moten, it looked like Tony Robinson might have gotten on the wrong side on that reverse. Watch the linebackers close. Armstrong and Moten, fine job. And there's big number 62 coming over for the Gators also, Alonzo Mitz.
At the 40-yard line, it is 3rd and 7 for the Volunteers of Tennessee. And that is the end of the first quarter. With the score here at Florida Field, Florida nothing, and the Tennessee Vols nothing, and we'll be back with the second quarter right after these messages. The second quarter, no score. The Volunteers of Tennessee in possession of the football, and Tony Robinson, the senior quarterback, standing up. He must be calling an audible. He's taking so much time. Drops back to throw, and he's being chased in there. Throws, and it is intercepted by Florida at the 23-yard line. Lewis Oliver, who has just gone into the football game, intercepted for the Gators. So they pick the football off, and a great play by young Oliver, the freshman from Belgrade. At it.
Ricky Knight is out of the ball game with an injury at this point. Lewis Oliver comes in at strong safety. The ball is tipped by Pennington and Tim McGee, and then Lewis Oliver picks the ball out of the sky for the Gators. First down on about the Gator 24-yard line.
So Florida takes over the football now, and we're just into the second quarter. I formation, Kerwin Bell at quarterback. Pitch coming to Neil Anderson, coming to the near side, slashes to the 30-yard line before he is brought down. Bringing him down is Brian Kimbrough, the outside linebacker for Tennessee.
Nice block by Jimmy Davis, offensive guard, sophomore from Apopka, number 67. Jimmy Davis doing a nice job. There's
Johnny Majors, Tennessee, 53-39-4, career record 1-10-82-6. 18th year as a head coach. He's gone to 4 straight bowls with the team from Knoxville. 2nd and 4 on the 30-yard line for the Gators. And the pitch again goes to Neil Anderson, and Neil Anderson's at the 40. He comes out of bounds on the near side, right at the 46-yard line. What acceleration that guy has when he hits the line.
It's a tremendous tailback, that toss pitch to the tailback, the bread and butter play for the Gators. Neil Anderson broke this play last year in Tennessee for an 80-yard touchdown. Watch John L. Williams up there. He's looking for somebody to hit, and he does the job. Neil Anderson scoots down the field. That tailback is very, very dangerous.
First and 10 as the Gators keep driving. Ball at the 46-yard line. That was a 16-yard carry for Neil. Now Kerwin Bell looks to throw. He's got John L. Williams incomplete. Coming out of the backfield on a little delay. Turned right around. And it goes as incomplete. Look at these happy youngsters from the University of Florida. They're Gator fans. You can tell that. Having a great time this afternoon.
Yeah, they're dressed for the heat, too, with those shorts and halter tops. And you and I are in a coat and tie. I think we're
doing something wrong.
Yeah. We need a senility test or something.
Second and 10 at the 46-yard line. for the Florida Gators. Slot offense with the I formation. Anthony Williams, the up back, and the give off goes to the tailback, and he gets to the 49. John L. Williams at the tailback spot, and Kerry Ziegler, the sophomore from Miami, makes the hit.
You know, there's tremendous pressure on the inside linebackers from both teams today. They've got to drop back and cover on pass protection. They've got to watch the quarterback so he doesn't run with the ball down the field, and then they got to stop those big running backs. The inside linebackers have a super tough job out there this afternoon.
Florida going with those three wideouts once again. Two wideouts in the slot, four wideouts. They've got two in the slot as Kerwin Bell looks to throw, being pressured by Tennessee, brought down way behind the line at the 34-yard line. Richard Cooper, number 77, was the first big guy in there, and he really put the pressure on Kerwin. So that brings on Ray Criswell. Third down and long yardage. The ball back at the 34-yard line. Criswell will boot away.
That was a big play by the Tennessee defense. They were stunning inside, and the Gators didn't communicate in that offensive line, and they gave up the sack.
Criswell gets the boot away. It'll be Andre Kramer fielding it for Tennessee, and he is brought down right at the 37-yard line by the Florida Gators special teams unit. And the first guy down there to bring him down,
Alonzo Mitz, I think.
Alonzo Mitz was the first guy to make the hit.
Tracy Daniels.
Tracy Daniels also on that. So they bring him down. You know, I've been impressed with the special teams the past couple of weeks. Over at LSU, they had a great second half. Now we wait for the snap as Tony Robinson, chance to signals, has to hang on to the football and drops the one knee back at the 34-yard line. And Florida's defense really putting on the pressure on Tony Robinson. Alonzo Johnson, the big sophomore from Springfield, Florida, first in there to make the tackle.
That was simply a broken play. Once in a while, you'll see the quarterback turn the wrong direction or make a mistake on his footwork, and he has to go down on that knee and take the quick loss.
Johnson really reacts to that so well. Second down for Tennessee, 15 to go on the 33-yard line. Still no score in the football game.
This is where Tony Robinson is so dangerous. He might run, he might pass.
He drops back, he's going to throw, dumps a quick one out, and he's got Keith Davis coming to the near side. Davis across the 40 and fights to the 43-yard line before Patrick Miller, the senior from Panama City, bulldogs him down for the Gators.
Well, we talked about the tough circumstances that the inside linebackers find themselves in. A well-designed screen pass by the Volunteers. Keith Davis gets the ball and moving down the field. Jarvis Williams making the tackle. That was a well-designed screen. Leon Pennington making the play.
Leon Pennington is sitting down there, too, at the 37-yard line, and the Chris Patrick and his crew are working over him right at the 37. So apparently something happened to him on that last play. That'll mean that Arthur White, a sophomore from Frostproof, will go in to take his place for the Gator defensive unit. Now he's getting up, walking off under his own power, and that's a great sign.
Jim, I think we got a great sense that these teams are very evenly matched to this point in the ball game. Neither team has come close to dominating the other one. They're playing pretty much the same kind of ball game against each other.
11:40 to play, as you see, in the second quarter, and no score. Third and four on the 44 for Tennessee. They're driving on Florida, and the Gator defense trying to put that pressure on. Flags all over that field as Tony Robinson drops back. And it looks like it could be an illegal procedure call or offsides against Tennessee, against the offensive tackle, Darrell Smith, 57.
What happened is Alonzo Johnson made a quick move at him, a quick jump, and that tackle is so paranoid about that great speed at that linebacker position, he doesn't want to get beat at the line of scrimmage, so he's thinking speed, 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 and all of a sudden Alonzo Johnson jumps at him, and he jumps offside himself.
Now, you were never paranoid during those 10 years in the NFL, were you?
Oh, no, no.
Third and nine on the 39-yard line as Tony Robinson waits for the snap. Slot offense. The slot would be to the right side. And two setbacks behind Robinson, who's looking to throw a quick one out of the backfield and taken down at the 40-yard line by Jarvis Williams is the receiver. William Howard, a sophomore fullback.
Great defense by the Florida Gators. Great defense.
So that means that Tennessee is going to have to punt away. And Bob Garmon, a sophomore, will do their punting. Number 41.
He hasn't had that much success to date. You see his average, 38.6. The Gators, we think, might have an edge in the punting game with their great All-American candidate, Ray Criswell.
And Ricky Natil is deep for Florida. There is the kick. It's coming to the near side and comes out of bounds right at the 22-yard line. So that nullifies the return. So that's exactly what the punter wanted to do.
Oh, it's a beautiful punt right there, too. And Ricky Natil can burn you at any time. And they were kicking away from him intentionally. But the Gators are looking at a fairly decent field position just outside their own 20-yard line.
First and 10 on the 22-yard line right now, Jim, as we are into the second quarter at Florida Field in Gainesville. Here you're looking at undefeated Galen Hall along the sideline. Waiting for the snap would be Kerwin Bell. He's got Williams and Anderson behind him, the motion man 9, Ray McDonald. Going to the top of your screen, the pitch comes to Neil Anderson, turns upfield and carries across the 30, or rather to John L. Williams, carries across the 30 to the 31-yard line, but there was a flag on that play. Andre Kramer made the tackle for Tennessee. Flag is going to go, it looks like, against Florida, and the preliminary indication from the field is for a hold. Going to set the Gators way back. And while they're walking that one off, we'll remind you that the winning attitude starts with individual performance combined with a strong team morale. Mid-State Federal Savings and Loan admires this spirit and is proud to be the exclusive sponsor of the Most Valuable Player of the Game Award, which will be announced at the conclusion of today's game. Mid-State Federal, Florida's full-service financial center. The hold against Florida sets the football back to the 12-yard line. It'll be first down and 20 for the Gators. As Kerwin Bell goes to work, the give-off goes to his setback, and he comes to the 28-yard line. John L. Williams brought down by Dale Jones, the outside linebacker from Tennessee.
Miller.
Well, that's an intelligent call. You don't give up a sack or the threat of a sack. You get a little bit more working room. Now it's a more manageable second and, 13 or 14. The Gators come back and pick up 7 or 8 here, and they'll be in good position on third down. That's probably what they're thinking.
Second down, 15. Ball at the 18-yard line. 9:32 to play in the second quarter. No score. Bell brought down way behind the line. Back at the 7-yard line. Tennessee's defensive unit really put the pressure on getting in there. Mark Povanik, a sophomore, right tackle, makes the hit.
You know, Tennessee's doing a lot of substituting out there because of the heat. These kids are doing a nice job mixing that Gator offensive lineup on their pass.
So that really puts the Gators deep in a hole. After that 11-yard loss, it'll be third and 26. Ball on the 7-yard line. Less than 9 minutes to play in the first half.
Excuse me, Jim. Tennessee is number 5 in the SEC in pass defense.
The pitch going to Anderson, turning upfield. He's across the 15, cuts across the 20, and goes to the 22-yard line before he's brought down by Chris White, the free safety for Tennessee.
Well, that's okay. The Gators aren't too disappointed right there. What have they done? They've given Ray Criswell a little bit more room to boom that ball down the field. Instead of being back inside their own 15, they're outside the 20. Ray Criswell can come out and give that ball a ride.
Well, here he is. Fine player from Orange Park, Florida, a senior, Andre Kramer, number 1, the return man for Tennessee. And Criswell does give it a ride all the way back to the 18. He's back to the 15, being chased across the field. And special teams, and what pressure they put on that young man. Just as he caught the football, they were down there, and it was Steve Stipe, number 95, who made the hit.
And maybe a clip to boot. Let's make a point right here. You saw that last run by Neil Anderson. Every play cannot be a touchdown or first down, obviously, but what that play did was give Ray Criswell a little bit more room, and he really did boom that football, didn't he?
Yes, he did. And not only did Tennessee get knocked back on that, but also they made the mistake of flipping. And so that's going to set the football way back to the 8-yard line. So just hang another star up for Jerry Anderson's special teams troops.
You betcha. What an advantage to have Ray Criswell on your team.
63-yard punt. It was a was so high, I thought it was going to bring rain. Tony Robinson looking to throw. Being brought down behind the five at the four-yard line. Henry Brown, the middle guard, the sophomore from Fort Myers, brings him down way back there. Look at that play.
A lot of problems for that nose guard. He's always got two or three guys on him, but Henry Brown doesn't give up on the play. Tony Robinson had rolled out to give himself a little bit more time to stay away from his end zone, but Henry Brown puts on great pressure there.
Second down, 14. Ball on the four. Tennessee back deep. Two backs behind Tony Robinson, the quarterback for Tennessee's Vols. He drops back to throw. Throws out in the flat, and it is incomplete. Jarvis Williams makes the tackle. It was intended for Pete Panuska coming out of the backfield, and Falls is incomplete.
Panuska was open. Tony Robinson, just the ball sailed on him a little bit, but Jarvis Williams was there in good protection.
Third down, 14, ball on the four, 7:25 to play in the second quarter, and still no score in the football game at Florida Field in Gainesville.
That's hard to believe, right, Jim Garrett?
It is, with these two great offenses.
Quick kick
by Tennessee. He boots it up high, and it's going to hit down at the 40, roll across the 45, and be down by Tennessee at the 46-yard line. But still, Florida takes it over with great field position.
I think you were a teenager the last time you saw a quick kick.
Just spit about that long.
But that's a brilliant play. If he had gotten the roll, the Gators would have been backed up a little bit. It didn't work to the extent that Tennessee wanted it to do. But I'm surprised that teams do not use that quick kick more often.
That was a staple with the old Tennessee teams many years ago. First and 10 at the 46. That punt went for 41 yards. Florida takes over the football. They're in Vol territory. The Vols with a 3-4 defense as they go with the three down linemen, the motion man, Ray McDonald, and the pitch coming to the near side to John L. Williams, who fights across the 40 to the 38-yard line before he is brought down by Tennessee. Good block there by Jack Grzina, the senior from Fort Pierce, and it was Lavoisier Fisher who made the tackle.
Well, wait a minute.
I thought we were in Baton Rouge
that's
for a
right.
minute.
Lavoisier Fisher, he must have got out of Louisiana somehow.
That's right.
Went to Tennessee, number 40.
7-yard carry for John L., second and three at the 39-yard line. Williams, a lone setback behind Kerwin Bell, and gets the call, turns outside, and fights for that first down yardage to the 32. What a tough guy. Of course, he's built for it at 6 feet, 222.
Got that low center of gravity, but what the Gators did, they're looking at 3 yards, so what do they say? We'll send two tight ends out there. We'll line up and run the ball, and you stop us. Tennessee was not able to stop him right there. First down for the Gators.
There was a strong safety, Tommy Sims, making the tackle for Tennessee. First and 10 on the 33-yard line. 6:20 to play in the second quarter. No score. John L., 6 for 27 this afternoon. I formation, and now Neil Anderson gets the call coming to the near side. Turns across the 25 and is driven out of bounds on the near side at the 23. A good carry for Neil Anderson, and he is bumped out of bounds by Tennessee here on the near side.
Again, John L. Williams making the block. When he doesn't carry the ball, when he doesn't catch the ball, he's out there blocking his buns off, I guess we can say.
Something like that. They keep him busy. Let us put it this way. I've said it before, I'll say it again. He reminds me so much of Jim Kick when he was with the Dolphins. He can do so many things well. He catches the ball well coming out of the backfield. He's a great, tough inside runner. He's got speed if he gets the opportunity, and he's a great blocker on pass blocking situations.
Yeah, you don't go on a vacation when you don't carry the ball. You work probably harder when you're not carrying the ball sometimes.
So it looks like the Gators have gotten the first down at the 22.
Well, the Gators have been bending somewhat, but Tennessee has not been able to score. Now we see Tennessee bending. It's going to be interesting to see if the Gators can get some point out of this beautiful, well-executed drive.
At the 22, Kerwin Bell, as McCarthy comes up over the football. Tennessee with a three-down lineman. The give to John L. Williams, and he is hit just as he hits the line of scrimmage. Very little gain on that play for the Tennessee volunteer defensive unit sniffs him out. Phil Stewart makes the tackle. Side as the Volunteers' Dale Jones and Richard Cooper combine on the stop, but there's a flag on that play.
Let me make a point right here. Sometimes the field judge and the back judge, when they're standing deep in the secondary and they see that guard pull out and he's isolated, you see a 300-pound guard running down the field, that gets your attention. The field judge and the back judge sometimes zero in on that kid and he'll make a block that's more like a tackle. They'll throw that flag holding, and that's exactly what happened right there.
You made a great point, because that is exactly what happened. Second down 10, the ball on the 33-yard line now for the Florida Gators. 5:30 to play in the first half. Still no score at Florida Field.
Important here not to get out of field goal territory, you know. Don't give up the sack and get out of field goal territory.
Neil Anderson averaging close to 6 yards per carry this afternoon. And here is Neil Anderson on the draw, straight up the middle. Before he is brought down, and he's brought down by Chris White for Tennessee. Nice block there by Gruzina for Florida.
Jack Gruzina, fifth-year senior, getting a chance to start when Greg Cleveland got hurt, doing a nice job out there.
Did an excellent job last week in his first-ever start at LSU in Baton Rouge. And here's Kerwin Cool Breeze Bell, as you call him. And I bet he wishes he had some cool breezes down there right now.
Well, out of all the players on that field, I believe Kerwin's the coolest out there right now for sure.
Third and nine on the 21 as Kerwin looks. He's being chased and brought down behind the line, looking for somebody open, but they were all pretty well covered. Brought down at the 25-yard line, and Hovanek brings him down number 59 for the Tennessee Vols defensive unit.
Well, he's mad that he got sacked. He didn't get the ball away, but they didn't give up too much yardage right there. They're still in field goal territory for Jeff Dawson.
We'll be right back, but first, these messages. Waiting for the field goal attempt, which will come from the 33-yard line. It'll be a 43-yard attempt by Jeff Dawson, and it splits the uprights. It is good. And so the Gators have taken the lead 3-0 over the Tennessee Vols. We'll be right back after these messages.
Follow the Gators from end zone to end zone with Gator Bait, Florida's number one sports weekly. Each issue is packed with loads of features. That's 38 exciting issues of Gator Bait. Plus, as a special bonus, we'll send you a free copy of our football yearbook, a 68-page guide to the Gators. Just send a check or money order for $30 to Gator Bait, P.O. Box 14022, Gainesville, 32604, or call collect 1-904-372-1215.
On the kickoff, the return is by Pete Panuska of Tennessee. He gets across the 20 to the 22-yard line. Steve Stipe brings him down for the University of Florida. There he is, number 36, on the return of the kick by John David Francis. So it'll be first down and 10, the ball on the 23-yard line for Tennessee. Florida has just jumped out to a 3-0 lead.
Brian Kimbrough was the young man that just got toted off before the field goal, and they'll miss him in that voluntary defense. Volunteer defense, excuse me.
First and 10 at the 23 for the Vols. Tony Robinson's give goes to the fullback, Keith Davis, and Davis over the right side across the 30-yard line. Curtis Stacy back in the football game and brings him down. 3 minutes and 45 seconds to play in the first half, and Florida has jumped out 3-0. 7 plays, 20 yards, 308, Jeff Dawson, 42-yard field goal.
These field goal kickers from the orange and blue can spoil you. Jeff Dawson is 7 for 7, and Bobby Raymond from last year was just incredible. I can't remember the last time the Gators missed a field goal.
Second and one on the 33-yard line now for the Tennessee Vols, as the Florida defense wants to put that pressure on them to give off those. throws to the fullback, Davis. He has got the first down as he goes to the 38-yard line. And brought down by Scott Armstrong and also by Gerald Dickens. Dickens, a junior from Plant City, and Armstrong, a junior from Ocala. So that'll be first down for the Volunteers of Tennessee with a little over 3 minutes to play in the first half, and the Gators leading 3-0 by virtue of Jeff Dawson's field goal. Slot offense waiting for the snap is Robinson. He throws, and it is complete to the midfield stripe, knocked out of bounds once he crosses to the Florida 48-yard line is the receiver Joey Clickscales, and he's knocked out by Jarvis Williams.
Clickscales made one of the prettiest catches I've seen in college football last year in the end zone in Knoxville for Tennessee. He's a fine receiver teaming up with world-class sprinter Tim McGee.
First and 10 on the 47-yard line. I formation being used now by the Volunteers of Tennessee. Robinson taking his time, calling the signals. Has had an audible, and Robinson drops back. Quick one to his back, coming out of the backfield on the swing pass, William Howard. And Howard is hit after a short gain by Stacy and Armstrong. Sounds like a law firm, doesn't it? Stacy and Armstrong.
It might be someday. Armstrong did a fine job right there, running with the back into the flat. Again, back to that inside linebacker point. These kids work so hard at that position. They got to be big and strong, and they have to be mobile as well. And you saw Scott Armstrong get out in the flat with the back right there.
But they couldn't be prosecutors. They'd have to be attorneys for the defense, right? Second and 9 at the 46-yard line for Tennessee as Robinson looks over the Florida defensive unit. Looking, being pressed way back there, scrambles out, throws, and it is complete. Falls down at the 25-yard line. Jeff Smith, a senior tight end for Tennessee. He was wide open.
There wasn't anyone near him. Tony Robinson, using that dimension with his running ability. Keith Williams thinks he has a sack, but he gets nothing but hot air. Tony Robinson looks down the field, finds his tight end, gets the ball down to Smith. Tennessee's moving the ball well.
22 yards, first and 10 at the 25 for the Vols as Tony Robinson looks, throws, and it is incomplete. Intended for Joey Clickscales and goes as incomplete. Good pressure put on there by Jarvis Williams. He was right there. Even had he caught the ball, would have brought him down right away. But the kind of whack that he put on him when he touched it, you can almost feel it up here.
Saban Uralian probably got very little sleep last night. He's the coach of the defensive backs, and he has a lot of respect for Jarvis Williams playing that man-to-man protection.
Robinson 10 for 15, 99 yards. A minute 38 to play first half, second and 10 at the 25-yard line. Split backfield. The give off on the draw goes to Keith Davis, and Davis rips and fights for yardage across the 20 to the 17-yard line before he's wrestled down by Curtis Stacy. He's a tough back, 6 feet, 190, well-built, close to the ground, comes off the ball very well.
Well, he's averaging about 74 yards a game on the rush. He's a freshman. He bounces off Scott Armstrong right there. Let's put this thing in perspective. John L. Williams is averaging about 68 yards a game rushing the ball. So Keith Davis is a fine young back.
Third down, one. Ball on the 16-yard line. A minute to play in the first half. The Vols with the football. The pitch goes to Panaska. Panaska comes to the far side, and he's brought down by Armstrong and Ricky Knight. He's got the first down. Tennessee gets the first down. They're trailing right now. The Gators up 3-0 by virtue of that 42-yard field goal. 51 seconds to play in the first half.
Patrick Miller coming into the ball game, giving Ron Moten a rest. Henry Brown coming in for Jeff Roth. They're trying to keep some fresh bodies out on that field.
Waiting for the snap is Tony Robinson on first and 10 at the Florida 15-yard line. Slot offense to the left side, split backfield behind the senior from Tallahassee. He slips down as he goes back to the 24-yard line. Very uncharacteristic of him.
Watch out for
slipping
watch
down.
Out for Tim McGee. 88 was wide open.
We'll be back with more, but first, these messages.
16 at the 23 of Florida for Tennessee. An 8-yard loss on the last play as Robinson slipped down. 21 seconds to play, first half. Robinson dropping, looking, throws a quick one out to Keith Davis, turns upfield and brought down by Florida as he hits the 16-yard line.
And they're going to call a quick timeout to stop the clock again.
Pennington and Mulberry combined to make the stop for the Gators.
12 seconds on the clock. Tennessee might have a chance for another play, but looks like they're going to go with a field goal attempt.
With 12 seconds to play, that's what they're going to do. And so they bring on their fine kicker, Carlos Reves. Junior from Miami, Florida, went to Killian High School. His older brother kicks for the Miami Dolphins.
Fuad Reves.
Fuad is great. Great kicker. So is this young man. He's been perfect on extra points this year, and he, earlier in the football game, missed his first field goal of the year. A long, long attempt, over 50 yards. And so the hold will come from Randy Sanders. And the snap from Joel Farmer. As Reves goes from the 23, a 33-yard attempt. His foot is into it, and it looks good. It is good. We've got a tie ball game, 3-3 in Gainesville as Tennessee ties it up, and 7 seconds left to play in the first half.
Two well-matched SEC rivals, a lot of talent on both teams. They're blow for blow with each other early in the first quarter, and again here in the second quarter. Neither team has given up anything of any consequences. 3-3, a lot of excitement, a lot of opportunity for each team in that second half.
Well, those 3 points by Tennessee, the first points scored against the Florida defense in the past 8 quarters. And that with just a few seconds left on the clock and an excellent kicker to do it.
And Tennessee coming in here with what was rated worst team in the SEC in terms of points.
I wonder who that guy is over there.
That's a real cheap seat, I guess that's what you call it.
It's probably got a little breeze, though. 11 plays, 61 yards, 3:59 possession time, the field goal from 33 yards away. And here is the kick, Neil Anderson in the receiving position as it bounces downfield, and Anderson steps out of bounds here on the near side at the 8-yard line with just 5 seconds left to play in the first half. So Neil Anderson in the receiving position now comes off the field, and Anthony Williams will go into the backfield in his place. He's a sophomore from Tampa Plan High School. First and 10 at the 8-yard line now for the Gators. 5 seconds to play in the first half. A 3-3 ball game at Florida Field. In a little bit, we'll speculate on what we think is going to happen in the second half. First half, they've marched up and down the field, but not too many points on the board. Kerwin Bell and Anthony Williams is the up back. Bell looking, drops down to one knee, and he will let the clock tick away, and that is the end of the first half of play. With the score, the University of Florida Fighting Gators 3 and the Volunteers of Tennessee 3, and we'll be right back with more, but first we'll take time out for these messages. At Florida Field, and very quickly before we start the second half, let's go down to the field and John Nugent, who had a chance to get some thoughts from Galen Hall.
Coach Hall is coming up at halftime. He mentioned a couple of things. Both offense not playing up to potential. Both defenses playing outstanding football games. As far as Kerwin Bell not getting enough time to throw, he said it was due to busted assignments. Something he'd have to take care of at halftime. We'll see how Kerwin does in the second half.
All right, thanks, John, for that report from the sideline as we get ready to begin the second half here at Florida Field. 3-3 is the score. The Gators with a field goal, and Tennessee with a field goal. National Car Rental is the official car rental company of the Florida Gators, and for reservations, call 1-800-CAR-RENT. That's 1-800-CAR-RENT.
Tennessee's going to get the football. Florida got it first in the first quarter. Here in the third quarter, Tennessee will have that football.
We'll
be having some action in just a moment, but right now we'd like to remind you that this telecast of Gator football is being seen by fans all over the state of Florida and the United States. No matter where you are, we'd like to hear from you. Send us a card or letter with a self-addressed stamped envelope, and we'll send you a Gator bumper sticker and a Gator keychain. Your comments also welcome. Send your card or letter to Gator Television Network, Post Office Box 14485, Gainesville, Florida 32604. And before the kickoff, we'd just like to thank all of you who have written in to give us your comments and appreciate these Gator telecasts. We really enjoy doing them for you.
Yeah, it was nice hearing from my mom. I'm glad she's having a nice vacation.
The card poured in, didn't it? 74,432 here at Florida Field today. Great crowd on hand for the action between the Vols of Tennessee and the Fighting Gators of the University of Florida.
Well, in terms of our mid-state MVP player of the game, maybe Jeff Dawson right now. This kid continues to be 100%, batting a thousand as he has kicked field goals this season. What is he, 7-7, 8-8? And he just continues to impress.
That's Joey Klinkscales, 87, who will be the deep return man for Tennessee as we get ready to begin the second half. And Francis moves to the football, boots it high. Klinkscales waits for it behind the line and drops down to one knee. Saw the thundering herd come down, decided to become a religious man and genuflected, and so they'll bring it out to the 20.
John David Francis has improved immensely in his kicking off, and here he drives Tennessee back into their own end zone. He had a lot of problems against Miami. Now he's consistently getting that ball deep in the end zone.
Tony Robinson, 12 for 17, over 100 yards. Galen Hall, head coach of the Florida Gators. 3-3 the score. High formation. Slot to the right side. Tony Robinson chants the signals on first and 10 from the 20 for the Vols of Tennessee. Tony Robinson quickly out in the flat to Klinkscales, who is drilled at the 22-yard line by Patrick Miller. Great reaction there by Miller.
Oh, yeah, Patrick Miller has plenty of speed. He can run step for step with any back or any receiver on the field. Watch Patrick Miller get out here in a hurry. He's almost getting clipped.
I'll tell you, it was dangerous, too. He had to make that tackle. Otherwise, it would have been a big game for Tennessee. Second and 8 at the 22. High formation for the Vols of Tennessee. They drive on Florida, and they're deep in their own territory. A pitch and a flag. The pitch went out to Keith Davis, the tailback for Tennessee, but there was a flag on the play, and the preliminary indication from the field is it's going to go against the Vols for illegal procedure.
Well, we keep talking about how the first series of each half is so important, and Tennessee comes right out here and doesn't gain much on the first down, and then they make a penalty. That's disappointing Johnny Majors, I'm sure. He wants to get off at a good start here early in the third quarter.
Second and call it 13, the ball on the 17-yard line. A split backfield behind Tony Robinson. Robinson drops, looks to pass, throws, and it is short, incomplete. Good coverage by Curtis Stacy. Pressure by Jeff Roth of the University of Florida Gator defense, who was right there to make Robinson unload the ball a lot earlier than he had planned to. So that's going to bring up third down, 13, the ball remaining on the 17-yard line. We are just into the second half, 3-3 the score.
You know what? Sam Garland does a nice job. He's 6'7". He always gets those hands up. Always gets the hands up, and he gave Tony Robinson some problems right there.
Waiting for the snap is Robinson. Third and long. Robinson scrambling, and the Gators drag him down at the 17-yard line. Williams and Roth for Florida. So Tennessee is going to have to kick out of there.
Jeff Roth made that play possible. He stayed at home. He put pressure on the center. He pushed him back. He gave Tony Robinson nowhere to go up the gut. Made the tackle. Jeff Roth.
We're waiting for the kick now, and Bob Garman will be punting for Tennessee. Great return man for Florida. Ricky Natil will be deep as Garman stands back there. He's had a 41-yarder this afternoon, and he's improved his average against Florida. He boots it off the side of his foot. It's going to hit down and come out of bounds right in front of the Florida bench at the 49-yard line. So the Gators get great field position.
Oh, They got tremendous field position. Now, I'm sure there were some adjustments made at halftime. I think the team that's going to win this game is the team that went in at halftime and figured the other folks out and are going to make those adjustments and move the ball more consistently, especially when they get close to the end zone. Gators have tremendous field position right here. They need to get pumped up on offense immediately.
First and 10 at the 49-yard line. Kerwin Bell, 6 for 8, 65 yards this afternoon. Receivers left and right. I formation pitch to Neil Anderson. Turns upfield and is stacked up as he hits the line of scrimmage right at the 49-yard line. Richard Brown, number 98, the middle guard for Tennessee. He's a senior from Revere Beach, Florida. Went to Suncoast High School down there, made the tackle.
Yes, and he had great mobility. He's supposed to get cut off by the backside lineman. They're supposed to clip him, which is an illegal play. But he's so quick, he was gone before the clip got to him, and he chased the play down.
Anderson, 11 for 73 in the first half. Split backfield behind Kerwin Bell, who looks the throw, and he's got a completion to Anderson. He's at the 40, and he's inside the 35 to the 33-yard line. Chris White makes the tackle on the good reception and good carry by Neil Anderson.
Well, we saw the Gators having pass protection problems, mainly mental mistakes earlier in the ballgame. Here they got great protection. He's able to hit Neil Anderson. The tailback's not used that much in the passing game by the Gators, but this might be one of the adjustments that they made at halftime.
17-yard reception, first and 10 at the 33-yard line for the Gators. The pitch comes to Anderson, and he gets across the 30 and inside the 30 to the 27-yard line. Brought down by Darren Miller, inside linebacker.
David Williams, big number 73, the freshman tackle from Lakeland, and Walter Odom, that fine blocking tight end from American High School in Miami. They're responsible for that game.
Second down, 4 at the 27-yard line for the Gators. Tickets still remain for the Florida versus Virginia Tech game on October 26th. For more information, you can call the Gator Ticket Office toll-free at 1-800-342-7851. Give to John L. Williams, and he is brought down just as he hits the line. Might have gotten a tough yard or two up to about the 25-yard line, 26-yard line is where they're going to spot it down. So it'll be third down and 2. And this is a tough call now with the ball on the 26-yard line.
Two tight ends in the ball game. The Gators are going to line up and say, we're going to run the ball. We're going to get this first down, Tennessee. See if you can stop us.
We might also want to mention for Gator fans that there are still some tickets left for the Southwest Louisiana game. The Raging Cajuns come to town next week. Third and 3 at the 26. McDonald, the motion man, picks to Neil Anderson. He's got the first down inside the 20. A fumble, and it rolls out of bounds on the near side. So we'll see what the ruling is from the field.
The ground cannot make you fumble, Jim Gallagher. I believe that's what they're going to say. Neil Anderson, I don't believe, was stripped of the ball before he hits the ground. Let's see. Fine blocking up front. There's big Jeff Zimmerman. He's moving like a freight train. And the ball did bounce out after Neil hit the ground.
First and 10 at the 17-yard line.
Did you see big Zimmerman there? He filled up the whole screen on the block.
He does block out the sun, doesn't he? 9-yard carry for Anderson. 3-3 to score. Gators driving. Give off John L. Williams. Inside the 10-yard line, down to the 9-yard line. Great carry by John L. What a bread and butter ball player he is. I hate to use that term, but that's what he is.
Oh, yeah. Well, he is the bread and butter player for the Gators, that fullback position. Again, you see the adjustment made. Two tight ends. Jack Garzina making a fine block, pulling from his tackle position. The Gators are just steamrolling right now, or that's what they're trying to do.
8 yards for John L. He's 8 for 34 this afternoon. Second and 2 at the 9-yard line. 10 minutes to play. Third quarter. 3-3 to score. Motion man Frankie Neal. Neil Anderson gets the call. Runs outside, and he's in the end zone. Neil Anderson goes into the end zone for the score to put the Gators up by a score of 9-3.
Obviously, Florida goes in at halftime, and the coaches gather the guys around and say, hey, we can run the ball if we stick with some basic plays. John L. Williams throws a great block for Neil Anderson. Neil Anderson, I believe, might have just broken Larry Smith's record for career touchdowns via the rush. Here we see Neil. Watch the blocking. Watch John L., 22. There's the block that makes the play possible, and big, strong Neil Anderson is in the end zone.
They're going to kick the extra point. He splits it right down the middle, and they're there's a flag on the play. Let's hang on because there was a flag on that last play. 10-3 is the score. We'll be right back. Well, there was a flag on the play just as we went away, and it nullified Dawson's extra point kick. And so then, while we were away, he kicked another one with the 5 yards tacked on, but there was another flag on the play. So now the football has moved out to the 13-yard line, and his kick is going to come from the 20 for a try for one. The Gators leading 9-3, and they're trying to make it 10-3. So let's watch. The hold will come from Ray Criswell. Bird is the snapper, and he just puts that right down the middle. Just a chip shot for Jeff Dawson. So now officially the score is Florida 10 and the Vols 3. We'll be back after this. Clinksdales receives for Tennessee's across the 10, the 15, down at the 17-yard line. The kick came from John David Francis for the University of Florida as the Gators kicked off after scoring and kicking the extra point. 10-3 the score. Florida's up. 7 plays, 49 yards, 3:21 possession time. Neil Anderson's 9-yard run and the extra point by Dawson was good, even though he had to kick it several times. The tackle was by Scott Marshall for Florida's special teams unit.
Yes, Jerry Anderson doing a fine job with those specialty teams. Anytime you get them inside the 20, you're doing a fine job with the kickoff team.
First and 10 on the 19 for Tennessee. Robinson rolls out, passes complete to the 21-yard line. And Arthur White makes the hit for the University of Florida. Sam Henderson was the receiver for Tennessee.
Here's those inside linebackers again. Boy, do they get the workout this afternoon, chasing the back in the flat. Look at the speed by Arthur White from Frostproof, Florida.
He's got great size, too, at 6'1", 215. Really can hurt you when he hits you. 9 minutes, 15 seconds to play, third quarter. The Gators lead it 10-3. Tony Robinson, as the Vols go with the eye, the pitch goes to Davis, coming to the near side, across the 20 to the 22-yard line. Alonzo Johnson makes the big hit, the senior from Springfield, Florida. Great All-American player for the Gators. Late in the fourth quarter, Jim and I will pick the Mid-State Federal Player of the Game at the end of the season. The scholarship will be awarded to the university in honor of the Mid-State Federal Player of the Year.
One thing that's happened here early in the third quarter, the fans are back in the game with the Gators, creating a lot of noise and havoc for that Tennessee offense.
They're down 8 on the 22 for Tennessee. Wing to the left side as Tony Robinson drops the throw and throws it out in the flat, and it is complete to the 32-yard line for Tennessee. And Curtis Stacy makes the hit for Florida. Clinksdales was the receiver, number 87. He's got great leaping ability. He looks, for some reason or other, he looks to be taller than 6'1". I guess it's because he goes up in the air about 15 feet. First and 10 at the 33-yard line now as the Vols start driving back against Florida in the I formation with a slot to the left side. Robinson, a great player, throws a quick one to Clinksdales, who is drilled right at the 31-yard line by Ron Moten. Moten was right there to make the hit, junior from Clearwater.
I tell you what, if you appreciate defense, you're getting an outstanding show by both teams, really. But the Gator defense right now is really shining. What a play by Ron Moten from Clearwater, Florida. He just jumped on that quick screen so fast, Clinksdales didn't have a chance.
It'll be second down, 11, ball on the 32. 7 minutes and 35 seconds to play in the third quarter. Dropping back, Robinson. The time, and let's see if they give him a completion on that. They say no completion. He's pretty upset about it. That was Eric Swenson, number 27 for Tennessee. Adrian White, the coverage man for Florida.
I think it's pretty obvious the ball did bounce. He was open. Good protection by that Tennessee line. You know, Alonzo Johnson's got that great speed outside, but the tackles from Tennessee are doing a fine job out there. Let's give those guys some credit. Darryl Smith, number 57, and David Douglas, big number 78 for the Volunteers.
Third and 11 on the 32-yard line. Robinson 16 for 23 this afternoon. Florida with the four down linemen. They're in the nickel. Dropping back is Robinson. Now he's going to try to scramble out. And now throws out in the flat.
knocks him down at the 39-yard line. Arthur White diagnoses it. William Howard was the receiver, and Robinson is limping as he goes off the field.
Listen to the ovation for that Gator defense shutting down Tennessee early here in the third quarter. There's a lot of football to play, but the Gator defense is starting to take control of this ballgame.
They were magnificent. Bob Garman, the sophomore punter for Tennessee, and Ricky Natil, the return man for the Gators. Garman gets off a high one. Natil fields it at the 22. He's at the 30, inside, and brought down at the 40-yard line. A nice return for Natil, giving the offense a nice place to set up shop.
Well, Tennessee's trying to avoid Ricky Natil handling that football, but they weren't able to do it right there. Ricky moves over, catches the ball in full stride, puts a little juke on a volunteer, and picks up an extra 5 yards. And boy, he was hit on the 40-yard line. Again, great field position for that Gator offense. Let's see if they stick with that powerful running game.
There's Albert. He made it back from Baton Rouge. First and 10 on the 40. 6:34 to play, third quarter. The Gators up 10-3. Bell pitches to John L. Williams, comes to the near side across the 40 to the 42-yard line. And Fred Bennett, sophomore nose man for Tennessee, brings him down.
This Bennett looks like Tim Newton from last year. He's a huge kid. They got him listed at 258, but I think that's probably only his left leg.
He's got a built like odd job, isn't he? Johnny Majors, four straight bowls for the Vols. Second and 8 on the 42-yard line. Irwin Bell to throw. Brought down behind the line of scrimmage at the 30-yard line. Way back there. Tennessee really came in and put the pressure on to bring him down. And it was Bob Jenkins, 58, who got in there. Looked like their 59 is walking off the field. That is Mark Halvanek, the right tackle. Let's take a look at it.
Well, there's some problems up front with communication, I think. That's all it is. The guys are supposed to either slide to the left or the right or communicate with each other on the double-team block, and they're just not getting it done. I don't think it's a matter of physical mistakes or getting beat physically. I just think they're not communicating, and they're going to have to straighten that out on the sideline.
11-yard loss on the play, and a volunteer is down on the field, but getting up now, and he's going to walk off under his own power, and that would be Mark Halvanek. He's a sophomore from Yorktown, Virginia. Albert the Alligator making some more friends. 5 minutes and 38 seconds to play third quarter. Gators lead it 10-3. Third and 19 on the 31-yard line for the Gators. Irwin Bell has been sacked 5 times for 45 yards. They've got the 4 wideouts in right now. Bell unloads. He's got Ray McDonald. He goes out of bounds on the far sideline at the 44-yard line. But it's not going to be enough for the first down. Terry Brown drove him out over there for the Vols.
Well, again, every series does not end up with points on the board. But look again at the field position Ray McDonald's going to give the Gators, and Ray Criswell will be able to boot the ball down the field once again. Good protection here for Kerwin. Ray McDonald does a fine job, almost turns it up, but the safety comes over and knocks him out short of the first down.
13 yards, number 13, Ray Criswell, the fine senior punter from Orange Park in the football game, will kick it away for the Gators and gets off a nice one. It's hanging high, and Kramer will field it at the 14-yard line. So Tennessee starts deep, as you so aptly point out, Jim.
Inside that 20. That's right, Jim Gallagher. Inside the 20 again. The Gator defense is pumped up. That's the kind of field position you want that defense to get out there and start with.
And so from the 14-yard line, it'll be first and 10 for the Vols with 5:16 to play here in the third period. And the Gators sitting up on that 10-3 lead.
I tell you, it's discouraging for an offense to continually start their offensive series inside their own 20-yard line. Tennessee would love to get the ball where Florida's getting it, but the Gators just haven't made that possible.
3-4 defense now being thrown up by Florida. You can see the three down linemen, the linebackers right in the gaps. Tony Robinson dropping. He's got the time. Throws a quick one out in the flat. Incomplete. Very well covered by Florida. It was intended for Sam Henderson coming out of the backfield. And Gerald Dickens, the junior inside linebacker from Plant City, was the coverage man for Florida and did an excellent job.
offensive 11 has been magnificent this afternoon. There's no doubt about that.
Well, and Tennessee's defense has done a great job as well. Obviously, by the points on the board, 10-3 with all this offensive talent on the field. Both defenses are really controlling the game.
Second and 10 on the 14-yard line for Tennessee. Giboff goes to the fullback. He hits into the middle for a gain of about a yard. Sam Henderson getting the call. Gerald Dickens makes the hit again for Florida.
You know, sometimes when a defense controls a ball game, it can be somewhat boring for a fan, but this is an exciting game. Everyone knows anything can happen almost at any time, but it's exciting to watch the defenses take control of the game.
4 minutes, 45 seconds to play third quarter.
Five backs.
So they're in the nickel on third and 7 from the 17 for Tennessee, and the Gators going to the nickel defense. Glover in the football game. Waiting for the snap is Robinson. Robinson dropping deep, and he's looking, and he is hit and brought down. Up on the play at the 5-yard line. Let's see what they rule. Jeff Roth was the guy that got in there and made the hit. And a big loss for Tennessee way back to the 7-yard line. He dropped the ball once he went down, and there he is sitting down on the ground. Just a moment ago, here's the replay.
Jeff Roth, number 96 from Seminole, giving Tony Robinson a twist there. Tony might be injured again. The ground cannot make you fumble. That's not a fumble. Nice pressure by Jeff Roth. And Tony Robinson might be having just a leg cramp or perhaps a knee sprain. Doesn't look too severe.
So the Tennessee training staff working over him with 4:08 to play in the third quarter. Florida with a 10-3 lead. The ball now back to the 7-yard line. It'll be fourth down and 17. And Ricky Natale, the great punt return man for the Florida Gators, the youngster from Newberry, Florida, Bob Garman, 4 for 37, 41 yards his longest this afternoon, will kick for Tennessee. He's standing way deep in his own end zone. Waiting on the snap, and there you see the end zone shot as Garman stands and waits deep. Gets it away, a little wobbly, and it's taken down, fair caught by Florida at the 33-yard line by Jarvis Williams, who is the up man on the punt return team.
Very intelligent play by Jarvis Williams. That's his job. Any short kick, any missed kick, he's supposed to get up there and catch that ball on the fly. Don't let it hit the ground. If it hits the ground, it's going to roll perhaps another 10 or 15 yards. Jarvis Williams did a terrific job moving up there and catching that punt.
First and 10 on the 37-yard line as the Bell system goes to work. Slot offense out to the left side for the Gators of Florida. 22, John L. Williams, the up back. Neil Anderson off the left side, turning it outside. He's across the 30, across the 20, and down to the 16-yard line. A great carry by Neil, brought down by Charles Davis, the free safety for Tennessee.
Okay, let's talk about three guys right here. On the blocks, John L. Williams, number 22, making a great block. Ray McDonald, number 8, the wide receiver, making a great block. Ricky Natale helping out down the field. Offense is a team effort. Defense is a team effort. See Ricky Natale right down there throwing a block? Ricky Natale helped Neil Anderson get about an extra 7 yards.
First and 10 for the Gators on the 16-yard line. High formation, and the give-off goes to Anderson, but Tennessee sniffed it out. They hit him right at the line. Maybe a short half yard. Richard Cooper, the first man to hit him, a sophomore for the Tennessee Vol defensive unit.
Well, the Gators have been blessed with great field position, and when you got a running attack with two talented kids like this big, strong Neil Anderson and John L. Williams, you're just going to sock it to your opponent till they can stop you.
Scored his 25th career touchdown at Florida earlier in the football game to put him past Larry Smith as the all-time leading touchdown rushing scorer for Florida. He's also the all-time leading ground gainer. He gets the call again. He's inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. Neil Anderson, Kerry Ziegler, inside linebacker from Miami Palmetto High School, makes the hit.
You know, that was quite a record touchdown via the rush. Larry Smith was a teammate of mine. I think he's one of the greatest backs in Florida history. Larry played 3 years for the Gators at the time in the 60s. Freshmen were not eligible, but Neil Anderson has just broken the record of one of Florida's greatest backs, Larry Smith.
He's a great back in the pros, too.
He sure was. He was the only rookie ever to start for George Allen, Larry Smith was.
Third and and three at the 9-yard line. The give goes to Neil Anderson, and he's across to the 5-yard line down to the four. Brought down by Richard Brown, the senior from Riviera Beach, Florida, from Suncoast High School. And Neil, 13 100-yard games.
Just a tremendous career. And look what's happening to the clock, Jim Gallagher. It keeps pumping down. 2 minutes and 4 seconds here in the third quarter. That Tennessee offense is sitting over on the bench. If Florida can score right here, it'll give them a tremendous edge, especially if they can get seven.
Number 22, the up back, John L. Williams, and he is the second man in Florida history as far as 100-yard games are concerned. Frankie Neal was the motion man. The give goes to Anderson, and he's down to the 2-yard line. Brought down by Lavoisier Fisher, a senior for the Tennessee Volunteer Defensive Unit. The Gators watching the happenings on the field. It's second down. Now for the Gators, and goal to go on the two. A minute 25 to play in the third quarter. Florida up 10-3. Frankie Neal, 21, coming to the bottom of your screen as he splits out of the picture.
Big Rodney
now
Johnson.
Back in a little closer on the wing.
Excuse
they got
me,
the
Jim.
Two tight ends in there, Jim. The give goes to Anderson in the end zone. Great, great play by Neil Anderson as he goes up over the top, doing his imitation of Greg Louganis, but against a lot of people.
Yeah, he got some height on that dive. It's impossible to stop a tailback with that kind of talent once he gets airborne. We were mentioning that Rodney Jones from Tampa playing in there at tight end, doing a fine job along with Walter Odom. At great field position for the Gators. They just marched down the field methodically and consistently, and the big strong tailback dives into the end zone.
Well, that was the picture-perfect drive. That's the way that you would do it if you wrote a textbook on how to do a drive, and they've moved down there, and now they lead by a score of 16-3, and we've got a player down on the field. We're not exactly sure who it is, and here's Neil going up over the top.
And you got to realize we're late in the third quarter, and this kid is tired. Imagine the height and distance he could get if he made that leap early in the first quarter.
Well, he's down on the field now, Jim, and when he went into the end zone on the dive, he did go down on his shoulder. So he's down, and Chris Patrick is working over him along with his crew right now.
Well, let's hope it's just exhaustion and it's not his shoulder. Let's take a peek here, see how he lands. He gets up so high, he's at least 6 feet in the air. You know, it's like landing in the street. That turf is so hard. It's got an asphalt base to it. And perhaps he might have strained that shoulder. I hope not.
Well, they have him up, and he is walking off the field under his own power. Seems to be moving his arms back and forth. So it looks like it could be just a combination of factors, just being shook up from hitting the hard turf, and also the fact that it is so hot on the field, and he was such a workhorse during that drive. So now we go for the extra point. The hold will come from Ray Criswell. Jeff Dawson will attempt the extra point, and there's the snap. And he boots it right through, and so the Gators of Florida have jumped out front on the Vols of Tennessee by a score of 17-3 here in the third quarter. 1:07 to play in this third period.
Well, that was a big 7 points for the University of Florida. Tennessee, as we've mentioned all afternoon, has tremendous talent on offense. Neil Anderson scoring on a drive that took 2 minutes and 47 seconds, 6 plays, 38 yards.
Every play where Florida ran the ball on that drive, Neil Anderson carried it.
Oh, he's got to be tired. Where's the oxygen? That's what he's saying.
That's it. Here's Johnny Majors. Now, here's a guy who was a great tailback himself at Tennessee. Runner-up for the Heisman Trophy in 1956. Some fellow named Horning from Notre Dame was the winner that year. Pete Panuska will be the deep return man for the Tennessee Vols as John David Francis, the freshman from Stark, Florida, puts the football on the tee and will boot it away. And what improvement we have seen in John David Francis since the beginning of the season.
Well, his job is to get the ball in the end zone. Let's see if he can do it. It's close.
Panuska at the one. He's across the five, the 10. Cuts upfield at the 15-yard line and across the 20. Between the 20 and the 21 as the Volunteers take over first and 10.
You know, Johnny Majors is going crazy. He's saying, why can't we get the field position that Florida's had? Why can't we get the ball near the 50-yard line? His offense consistently is starting inside or on their own 20.
Give Joe George the credit for that tackle for the Florida special teams. First and 10 on the 21-yard line now for the Volunteers. They trail 17-3 with a minute to play in the third quarter. Tony Robinson, who's gone all the way at quarterback this afternoon, looks over the Florida defensive unit, throws a quick look in, and he's complete. Oh, the ball is dropped at the 35-yard line. Arthur White, the big play man for the Gators as they get the football again. Henry Brown and Arthur White. Henry Brown recovers the football. Let's take a look at it.
Tim McGee might be the best receiver in the conference. He gets sandwiched right there by Ricky Knight and Arthur White. The ball pops free, and I think Alonzo got it.
Whoever got it, there were a lot of dark orange shirts around the football. First and 10 at the 35-yard line now for the Gators. They're up 17-3. 54 seconds. There is Arthur White, 6'1", 219, a sophomore. Frost, what a game he's had.
Frostproof Florida.
That's right down in the middle of the state. You're part of the world. John L. Williams on the flea flicker, throwing long on the halfback pass for the end zone, intercepted by Tennessee, and being dragged into the end zone by Frankie Neal, who was the intended receiver, going up high for Tennessee and taking the ball down was their deep defensive back, Terry Brown, the left corner man, and so he takes it down and is dragged down right away by Neal, so Tennessee gets the ball back, but at the one-yard line. Now for the injury report on Neal Anderson, let's go to the field and John Nugent.
Jim, the status of Neal Anderson, when he scored that touchdown, he landed on the ball, knocked the wind out of him. We expect him back in this ball game. Gentlemen.
That's great news. Thanks very much, John, for that report. 17-3, the score. The Gators lead the Vols. First and 10 on the 2 for the Volunteers of Tennessee. I formation as Tony Robinson gives off to the tailback, who is stacked up very close to the line. The Gators think it should be a safety, Keith Davis, but they're not going to give it to him. Alonzo Johnson was right there.
Let's go back to the previous play where John L. throws the interception. You put yourself in his shoes. You're a senior. You're a team's head 17-3. You get a chance to throw the ball, you're going to let it fly. You can't blame him for trying, you know.
That's right.
And that looked like as close as you could get to a safety by the defense on that play.
Well, Neal Anderson is 1-for-1 in the passing department this year after last week at Baton Rouge. John is 0-for-1, but he's pretty good in all the other categories. Robinson really lets it sail deep downfield. Flag on the play, and Adrian White was there for the University of Florida defensive unit. A deep receiver for Tennessee, running just a fly pattern on the outside and bumped out of bounds on the far side, so call could be against Florida.
Yeah, I think they're getting Adrian White, but I don't have a problem with this play at all unless he throws his elbow. You have a perfect right to knock the guy's head off if you can, but if you throw the elbow, I don't know. Maybe they said the ball was uncatchable and he should not have made the hit, but you cannot fault a kid for trying to make a hit like that. That's what football's all about.
That's the end of the third quarter with the score, the Gators of Florida 17 and the Volunteers of Tennessee 3 here at Florida Field on a hot afternoon. We'll be right back with more action. Now we're going to hang on and we're going to keep on talking right here as we get the word. Quarter cannot end on a penalty, so we're going to stay here for a while as they go back upfield.
And on pass interference, what they do is they come back to the line of scrimmage and they march off 15 yards. Instead of the penalty being around the 40-yard line, they're going to come back to the line of scrimmage. Personal foul, I believe.
All right, let's see what they do. Well, what they did was they marched off the penalty, and they have ended the quarter, and now they've moved downfield. We'll be right back after these messages. Down Tony Robinson let fly as we begin the fourth quarter. A deep pass downfield to Joey Klinkscales. It is complete inside the 20-yard line to the 19.
And we might mention, since we're not a national production, we can't control the referees, and they let the play fly while we were out on commercial. It's a technical problem we had no control over, but boy, did he throw the ball down the field.
61-yard reception. Ricky Knight brought him down and saved the touchdown. First and 10 on the 19-yard line for Tennessee in the eye as Tony Robinson directs the attack for the balls. Fumble on the play. Let's see who got it. Right at the line of scrimmage. It looks like they just had a mix-up in the backfield, but the ball went on the ground, recovered by Tennessee.
We might mention that on the play, it was a bootleg action, and Tony Robinson really let the ball fly down the field. Here we see his fumble. It's being kicked by his back into the line of scrimmage, but Tennessee's going to pounce on it.
So that brings up second down 11 on the 20-yard line for Tennessee. Defense, the three down linemen trying to put the pressure on Robinson. Time to throw, throws, touchdown Tennessee. He's got Kim McGee, number 88, for the TD right there for the Volunteers, running a perfect post pattern right at the post, just like you're supposed to do.
Well, he got behind Patrick Miller and just in front of Ricky Knight, and he had that great speed on the break to get open. Tennessee's in this ball game,
and so that means the try for the extra point. Reves will make the try from Miami, Florida, Killian High School. Waiting for the snap now is the holder. And there is the kick for the extra point, and it is good. And the score right now, the University of Florida 17, and the Vols of Tennessee 10. We'll be back after this. Tennessee. Ricky Natale will take it in the Florida end zone, drop down to one knee, and it'll come out to the 20-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for the Gators now as they go to work offensively, leading this football game 17-10. And here in the fourth quarter, the scoring drive by Tennessee. Five plays, 98 yards, 152 the possession time. Tim McGee, 20-yard pass to Tony Robinson. Today's kick good, and so it is suddenly 17-10.
Well, you expected that time bomb to go off eventually. Tim McGee entered the ball game catching about 25 yards per catch, and Klinkscales has a high average in the 20s also. So you knew that bomb was going to happen eventually.
That's right. And now here is Kerwin Bell with the I formation. The pitch goes to Neil Anderson, turns upfield, and almost picks up the first down. Goes to the 29-yard line before he's brought down by Tennessee. Nice carry by Neil. Andre Kramer makes the hit for the Vols. A 9-yard carry. 13 minutes, 30 seconds to play here in the final quarter at Florida Field in Gainesville.
13:26 to go, and the clock is ticking.
The Gators, 3-0-1, 2-0 in the SEC. There's the give, and it goes to, once again, Neil Anderson, and he tries it off the left side for the first down. What a great player he's been this afternoon. Not that he hasn't been a fantastic player for 4 years, but it just seems like, if you can believe this, to me it seems like he gets almost better every game. First and 10 at the 31-yard line now for the Florida Gators, trying to get a possession drive going here. John L. Williams will be the fullback. First downs, Tennessee 14, Florida 13, even in that category. John L. takes the pitch, comes to the near side, tries to turn the corner. Tennessee sniffs him out, brings him down. Dale Jones, a junior outside linebacker, takes him down for the Bernard.
Dale Jones was able to beat the block of the tight end right there and wrap John L. Williams up now. The Gators are not going to go in a shell. They know that would be a mistake. They're going to continue to run their offense. They got a 7-point lead. If they go in a shell, they're going to give Tennessee some extra momentum possibly. So they're going to continue to run with their game plan.
Jones had 34 tackles coming into this game and has had an excellent afternoon. Second and 12 at the 29 as Kerwin Bell looks to throw. He does. He's got Neil Anderson at the 35-yard line. Hit and brought down right away by Terry Brown.
That's what I was talking about, not going in a shell. They're not worried about throwing the ball. They got guys that can catch it. They got a quarterback that knows how to get them the ball, and they're going to throw the ball when they have to.
Third down, 6 on the 35-yard line now for Receivers left and right with a throw set. Split backs behind. Bell, who drops the throw. He does, and it is complete on the near side for the first down to Ricky Nateel. Coming out of bounds at the 47-yard line. Right in front of the Florida bench. What a nice out pattern.
What a job by Kerwin Bell. Dale Jones does a nice job, number 54, the linebacker, dropping in his zone, but Kerwin just lays it right over Jones. Watch him. He just was able to tip it, but Ricky Nateel caught the pass. Just a fine job by Kerwin Bell, dumping that ball just over the quarterback, linebacker's reach.
First and 10 now at the 46-yard line for the Gators here in the final quarter, and the give-off goes to John L. Williams. He fights up to the 41-yard line, fumble on the play, and Tennessee has recovered. The Volunteers recover the football. Charles Davis makes the recovery, the free safety. That's something you don't see very often.
What's going to happen, though, when you get tired, you carry the ball as much as those kids do, you're going to make mistakes, you're going to fumble once in a while. It's come see, come sigh. You give one, you take one.
So warm on that field. The temperature prior to game time, 116 degrees. First and 10 on the 41-yard line now for the Volunteers. Score 17-10. The Gators trying to protect their lead. Tony Robinson rolling out, looking, throwing on the run, and he is complete to the 40-yard line, across the 35 and down to the 34-yard line is Tennessee's receiver, and that would be Tim McGee, and bringing him down for Florida would be Jarvis Williams.
Same play that they hit Joey Clinkscales with on a touchdown, on the long bomb a little while earlier. Bootleg action. This time Clinkscales clears out the area. Tim McGee just gets down there and sits down. Look at the open space.
Well, the way that Robinson scrambles, too, gives them another dimension. First and 10 at the 34-yard line now for Tennessee as they drive on Florida. The Florida defensive unit has to really go to work now. Bend but not break, and they bring down Keith Davis as he tries it off the left side. Ron Moten makes a hit for the Gators.
Bootleg action is so tough when you get a quarterback with Tony Robinson's ability rolling outside, and then you get burned earlier by Clinkscales, and you're apprehensive about that long pass again, and you open up some zones inside, and then Tim McGee sneaks down there and catches the ball.
Second and 7 on the 31-yard line as Robinson makes an adjustment. Puts a split back behind him when he started with the eye. And now Robinson pitches to the near side to Keith Davis. And the Gators sniff it out and bring him down right at the 30. Leon Pennington, the inside linebacker, the first hitman for Florida.
And Ricky Knight from strong safety doing a fine job stuffing that option.
Third down, 7 at the 31. This will be an important play coming up. 9:52 to play in the football game.
Yeah, if they can get a field goal right here, they're a real threat to win the ball game.
And now waiting for the snap is Tony Robinson. Great height, 6'3". Looking. He brought down behind the line at the 39-yard line. Alonzo Johnson there with Keith Williams in the middle of the Gator defensive unit. Boy, did they respond and react on that play.
And perhaps took Tennessee out of field goal territory. Tony Robinson had a sense of that great speed coming from the outside. He felt Clifford Charlton coming. He felt Alonzo Johnson coming. He tried to step up, but the big nose tackle was there. And he didn't have anywhere to go, and they swarmed all over him. Watch what happens. Watch the penetration by Keith Williams and 96 Jeff Roth. Look at the speed coming from outside. He didn't have a chance. My goodness, they're going to try a 55-yard field goal.
From the 45, so it'll be a 55-yard attempt. And everyone was scrambling around so much there. They've taken a timeout. They first, the punting unit went on the field, and then they started to go off. And some of the guys play on the punting unit. The special teams people are on the punt unit, and they're also on the field goal unit. And so there was a little confusion there. So Tennessee takes a timeout. It's 4th and 14, and the ball is actually resting on the 37-yard line. They're going to try the field goal from the 45. As Jim points out, a 55-yard attempt for Reves.
And again, the Gator defense rises to the occasion. They're being threatened. Tennessee has some confidence on offense. They're now moving the ball rather easily. And all of a sudden, the defense rises up and sacks the quarterback.
this an extremely difficult 55-yard attempt. But these kids are so good these days. Looks like they're reconsidering, maybe going with a punt.
Yeah, they are, because the punter, Bob Garman, 41, has just come on the field. So I think they're going to try to punt it away. It's just too much pressure to put the young man under to try to expect him to kick it from 55 yards away.
That's true, Jim. Watch for the fake. I'm sure the kick team has been told, be careful, be careful. Watch for the fake. In this kind of territory, they might try it.
Well, looks like the Gator defense, the way they're lining up, is going to be coming right at him. And he does go ahead and boot it away, and he's going for the corner, Coffin corner. And Tennessee gets down under it, and they snap it back to the one-yard line. Nice play by the special teams unit. And Benalt, the referee first indicated it was going to go down at the two-yard line, but now he indicates that, let's take a look at it.
Oh, man, was that ever close?
Well, one official was right there on the line, so he was in position to make the call, and he did make the call that it was in the end zone, so it comes out to the 20-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for the Gators with 8:39 to play.
Big break for that Gator offense. Imagine right now being back on your own one-foot line with Tennessee only a touchdown behind.
Saw just a moment ago a pretty interesting view, an orange balloon. If you like oranges, this is the place to be today. 35-yard kick by Garman of Tennessee. The give-off goes to Neil Anderson up the middle. Gets a couple of yards, but the Volunteer defense takes him down after that short game.
Back to the team concept. Now that Gator offense has to get out there and eat up some of this clock and give their teammates on defense a bit of a rest so they can come back and match up with that great talent that Tony Robinson has. Right now, the Gators have to think first down. First down. One first down at a time. Think first down.
8:15 to play in the game. The Gators with the football. Second and 8 on the 22. Bell to throw. Throws. He's got Johnny Williams at the 25. He's at the 30. And to the 38-yard line before he's brought down and a first down. Let's take a look at it again.
This is an example of why Galen Hall is undefeated. He refuses to get in the closet and hide with his offense. He comes out throwing the ball. He's got the talented quarterback. He's got the kid that can catch it in the flat, John L. Williams. What we were saying, think first down. Now they got it. There goes that clock. That clock continues to tick. That clock's an ally of the Florida Gators right now.
First and 10 at the 33. The give off goes to Anderson right up the middle across the 35 to the 37-yard line. Blocked by Jack Grazina. Darren Miller makes the hit.
And Neil Anderson is on the edge of maybe 150 yards in this game right now. A tremendous performance. Look how tired that kid is. You know he's just exhausted, but he knows he's got 7 minutes to go. A big SEC battle, and he's going to keep battling out there.
Well, you know, Jim, Neil Anderson has played very well, and I think he deserves our consideration for the Mid-State Federal Player of the Game, which we're going to be picking in a few minutes. Split backfield now behind Kerwin Bell. With the receivers left and right, Bell dropping the throw. On second and 6, throws, and it is complete to Ray McDonald. Brought down just before he hits the 50 at the 49-yard line, and another first down. Someone was listening to you. Somebody up there on headphones was listening to you say, put together first down after first down.
Well, they're doing it. Charles Kimbrough making the tackle out there in the flat. This is what makes a champion, okay? Regardless of what happens in the remaining 6 minutes, the Gators are playing like a champion at this moment. They're eating up the clock. They're moving the ball down the field. They're giving their defense a rest. That's how championships are played.
First and 10 at the 48-yard line. And the give-off goes to Neil Anderson. And he hits to the midfield stripe for a couple of tough yards on the play. Tennessee's Richard Brown, the middle guard from Riviera Beach, Florida, Suncoast High School, brings him down. Here's Kerwin, 12 for 14, 143 yards.
That's a pretty good day's work, isn't it? 12 of 14. This kid is so consistent, week after week.
Mr. Consistency. Second and 9. Right at the midfield stripe. End zone shot of the Gators. Split backfield behind Kerwin Bell. Bell hangs onto it and is brought down behind the line. Let's see if they rule that that was a fumble. No, that was not a fumble. They lost the football. I think everybody got a little bit excited. But as you point out, the ground can't cause a fumble. So it still remains Florida's football. But they lose on that. And here comes an important third down for them with 5:34 to play.
Tennessee's defense. Again, they realize they have to rise to the occasion. They have to get their offense back on the field. Just like that sack a few minutes ago helped the Gators. Here we see Tennessee sacking the Gator offense and helping themselves, helping their cause.
Third and 13 at the 46-yard line. Waiting for the snap is Kerwin Bell. There's a flag on the play, a couple of flags as Bell goes way long. There are flags all over this field. It looks like Tennessee's deep back held up Ray McDonald.
And I think the Gators might have been in motion at the line of scrimmage. Perhaps it's offsetting penalties. Maybe they're calling them both against the Gators. Let's see what's going to happen.
Well, a lot of flags on the field. 5:07 to play. The Gators lead 17-10. The Vols 2-0-1 coming in here, and Florida 3-0-1, coming off a big win over LSU last week in Baton Rouge, and the week before over Mississippi State.
The Gators went with a quick count right there, a little bit quicker count than they've been going with, and I don't think the guys were set at the line of scrimmage. Yep, that's what they're calling them, offsetting.
Offsetting penalties. So we go back to the drawing board as Johnny Majors walks along the sidelines with the headset. And so Florida has the football still. It's third and 13, and the ball remains at the 46-yard line. Yeah, so the call was for illegal motion.
Illegal motion against Florida and a pass interference against Tennessee.
And now the Florida Gators calling timeout because Kerwin Bell wants to come over and talk things over with Galen Hall, and we'll be right back with a score, Florida 17 and Tennessee 10. Third and 13 at the 46. 5:05 to play. Florida's got the football on their side of midfield. And Kerwin Bell looking, rolling. Chase out of bounds. Oh.
And also pretty stupid. I know Johnny Majors can't believe his kids did that. Here they had Florida stop. Florida was going to be forced into a punting situation. Whenever you play on defense, you got to be aggressive, but you got to be aware where you are on the field. Watch this late hit.
So it's 77 Richard Cooper that took him. And so a big penalty.
Automatic first
against
down.
The Tennessee Vols, and an automatic first down for the Gators at the 40. First and 10 for the Gators at the 40 of Tennessee. And they're going to be regretting that one for a while. 17-10, 4:57 to play in the game. The Gators in possession of the football.
And again,
high formation.
And again, think first down. Right now, that's all they want to think about is first down.
Kerwin Bell taking his time. Tennessee digging in. The pitch goes to Anderson, turns outside, and is driven out of bounds in front of the Tennessee bench at about the 37-38-yard line. We'll see where they spot it down.
One thing the backs have to think about is stay in bounds. Don't get out of bounds and stop that clock. Now, Neal went down on a knee right there. The clock did not stop, but they got to be a little more cautious about that sideline staying in bounds.
27 for 154 against Tennessee, and last year he had an even better game against the Volunteers. Over 170 yards. Second and 7 at the 37-yard line. Gator cheerleaders. As Kerwin Bell hands off to Neal Anderson, he goes across the 35 and down to the 34-yard line. That'll bring up third down and short, and a tough call. 4 minutes and 2 seconds to play.
It is a tough.
Keeps moving.
It is a tough call, and another consequence is, will they go for it on fourth down? You know, it might be out of field goal territory, but will they try for the first down if they don't make it right here? That's something to look forward to.
Third and 4 on the 34, a lone setback behind Kerwin Bell. The give off goes to John L. Williams, and he is hit behind the line and goes down. And the Volunteer defense gets in there, and Hovannik, 59, makes the hit.
And that's a big loss. That big loss is going to take away the choice of going for it on fourth down. If they had been close, they might have given some thought to running a fourth down play. Just a fine job by Tennessee. Number 59, Mark Hovannik, penetrating, making the tackle in the backfield.
Fourth and 6 at the 36. And so what they're going to do is punt, because Criswell's in there, and he is standing right at the 50-yard line waiting on the snap. Kramer, number 1.
one will be the return man for the Volunteers. Criswell going for the corner, and it will be knocked down between the 10 and the 11-yard line. They say it's there. It went down at about the 13-yard line. So nice play by the Gators because they put Tennessee way back there. So Tennessee takes over the football right now. First and 10. They say it's at the 13-yard line. Less than 3 minutes to play in the game. 2:50. And it's a 17-10 game. The Gators leading Tennessee. You got to know right now that Majors is going to pull out all the stops.
Yeah, he's going to be thinking a lot more than first down. He's going to be thinking bomb. Get the ball down the field in a hurry.
And they can do it, too. So the Florida defense is going to be really tested. Three down linemen. They go with a 3-4 defense. The Volunteers, Tony Robinson waits on this snap. Tony Robinson looks to throw. He's looking out there in the flat, and it is complete to McGee on the near side, and he's pushed out of bounds right here on the near side by Curtis Stacy of Florida.
McGee's got so much speed that when the quarterback has some time, he can really get down the field on his routes. Look at the protection that Robinson's getting right here, and there's McGee behind the linebackers in front of the deep backs, and he steps out of bounds coolly and stops the clock. Florida has a 14-game unbeaten streak, the longest in the nation. Tennessee is going to threaten that record this afternoon.
Waiting on this snap is Tony Robinson on first and 10 from the 34-yard line. Robinson looks to throw, and he throws one out there again complete to McGee at the 41-yard line. Brought down by Leon Pennington of Florida along with Dwayne Glover. And now Tennessee in the hurry-up offense. Their first down had stopped the clock, and the clock continues to tick right now. So they're in the hurry-up. Again, Robinson dropping, looking for somebody, throws out there, and it is complete for the first down into Florida territory. Moves across to the 47-yard line. Receiver Eric Swanson, senior from San Bernardino, California. There's the clock, and that's the story. 2:12, Gator 17, Vols 10. Gator defense trying to protect the lead. Volunteers trying to get in the end zone. Little confusion, little mix-up here. As Robinson takes a look, the clock has begun again. It's ticking down. 2:04, Tony Robinson dropping. Being pressed, still on his feet, scrambles out of the pocket. Oh. And blocked!
Intercepted!
Weston, 68, is going to make the block.
Rondy Weston.
And it bounces into the hands of Alonzo Johnson, and the Gator offense gets the ball back, and what a big play by the magnificent 11. Oh, my goodness, less than 2 minutes to play here at Florida Field. 17-10.
It was almost as if Clifford Charlton knew the snap count. He was in the backfield so quickly. Tony Robinson did escape, though, and there's Rondy Weston. Was it Rondy Weston that knocked the ball up in the air?
Big number 68 got right in there and knocked it in the air.
And then Alonzo sitting there, the ball falls out of the sky in his lap.
That was what he was waiting for all afternoon.
You bet.
Big play by the Gator defensive unit. They've been a great story. First and 10 on the 47 now is the situation, and the Gators have the football.
No turnovers. University of Florida, the Gators got to be thinking no turnovers. And again, I hate to be redundant, but back to that first down, eat the clock up. First down, eat the clock up. No turnovers. It's extremely critical right now.
Yes, it is. And here goes Kerwin Bell back in, 12 for 14, 143 yards against the Vols as he directs the attack. These Gators are tough here at Florida Field. First and 10 on the 47. High formation. Receivers left and right for the Gators. Kerwin Bell. The give off goes to Neil Anderson, who hits into the line. He's brought down, short gain on the play. And we'll be right back with more from Florida Field. But first, timeout for these messages. On second down, Neil Anderson gets the call and goes to the 42-yard line for ticks away. And again, the whistle's on the field as Tennessee is trying to use the timeouts to hold it up. And so there is Neil Anderson standing on the field right now. And Neil Anderson has had a great game this afternoon. And Mid-State Federal Savings and Loan is performance-minded and is proud to recognize outstanding individual performance with Mid-State's Most Valuable Player of the Game Award. Physical fitness, keen mental concentration, and true spirit to win, what Gator football is all about today and in the future. And our winner today, Neil Anderson.
And no timeouts left for Tennessee. No timeouts.
There is Neil, the senior from Graceville, Florida. Just a great, great player. Gil Brandt, who is thought to be one of the geniuses of professional football, just feels that he is just a great and complete back. So you know he's going to go very, very early in the draft. For 23.
If I was an attorney, I'd say I concur.
Third and six on the 43-yard line. The Gators, owners of the longest unbeaten streak in the nation, 17-10, lead the Vols, 1:39 to play. And Kerwin Bell looking and going long for Frankie Neal. Deep at the 10-yard line. So that brings up fourth down, and that's going to put that defense to the test one more time as Frankie Neal comes off the field. 1:32 to play, and the Volunteers get a shot at the football again.
Well, it was there. It could have worked. It was close. He just overthrew him a shade.
Waiting for the snap is Ray Criswell with 1:32 to play, and he'll be kicking away for the Gators on fourth down from the 43. Going for the corner, gets it up there high, and it will bounce out of bounds on the near side at the 19-yard line. So Tony Robinson comes on the field once again, and it'll be first and 10 with 1:23 to play in the game.
And this kid, Tony Robinson, at this point in the game has close to 300 yards passing the football. We told you he was a great quarterback. At this point already, he's got close to 300 yards. Let's see what he can do with his Volunteer offense with 1:23 to go.
17-10 the score. The Florida defense trying to protect that 7-point lead. And here is the Tennessee offense. Tony Robinson, the senior from Tallahassee, been a great player for the Volunteers, dropping back, looking to find somebody. Brought down at the 20-yard line by Alonzo Johnson. Let's go down now to the field and John Nugent for this report on the crowd.
Jim, University fans and officials were concerned that there might be some trouble in the stands today. I talked with security. They said there hasn't been an incident all day. They say Gator fans get an A-plus for behavior.
That's great to hear. Tony Robinson dropping back on 2nd and 9 at the 21. Looking, throws a quick one out in the flat, and he steps out of bounds here on the near side. And the receiver for Tennessee just stepped right out of bounds. That was Sam Henderson who made the reception. And so the clock stops as we go to third down.
And Tennessee's really in a bind, having no timeouts left, and they're looking to get that big gainer in a hurry. The Gators have five defensive backs in there: Curtis Stacy, Adrian White, Ricky Knight, Ricky Mulberry, Dwayne Glover.
51 seconds to play, 17-10, 3rd and 5 at the 25. Tony Robinson looks to throw, goes long, incomplete. Intended for Eric Swanson, falls as incomplete. The Gator Hotline with Galen Hall. Radio call-in show is aired every Wednesday during football season from 7:07 until 8 p.m. on most of the Gator radio network stations. Be sure to tune in every Wednesday evening.
Fourth down, they don't have a choice. They're going to have to go for it, and they could pick it up.
45 seconds, 4th and 5 on the 25-yard line for the Volunteers.
Crowd is on their feet. They're cheering that defense on.
It's been a great football game this afternoon at Florida Field. The defense has been superb. Tony Robinson looking to throw. He's got the time. Throws. Got McGee, and he is hit before he gets the first down. Leon Pennington makes the hit. Let's take a look at it again.
This kid is really hurt, too. He gets powdered by
field right now at the 27-yard line. So the Gators take it over, and it's first and 10 with 36 seconds to play. And they've got to try to protect that lead. Tony Robinson walks along the sideline. He can hold his head high. He's a great player. He's had a great game this afternoon, a senior from Tallahassee Leon High School.
Jim Gallagher, since 1981, the University of Florida Fighting Gators are 23-1-2 here in Gainesville at Florida Field. What an awesome home record that is. I believe it was Dalton Hilliard's freshman year when he came here in 82. That's the last time the Gators lost. In 81, they were undefeated. They lost one in 82. None in 83 or 84, and none in 85.
They've been super at home. First and 10 at the 29-yard line. As Kerwin Bell drops to one knee, and the clock ticks away here at Florida Field. The Gators up 17-10. Bell doing his Don Strock imitation, dropping to one knee as the Gators try to salt this one away. And that is going to be the last play of the football game as the Gator players shake hands with the Volunteers from Tennessee. And the Gators win it 17-10 at Florida Field, as Jim so aptly points out. They've just been superb here on their own home turf. And here is Galen Hall. He remains unbeaten as he walks across the field. And Florida, proud possessors of the nation's longest win streak. Shake hands with Johnny Majors, whose Volunteer football team played so well this afternoon to fall 17-10 to a great Florida aggregation.
Now, Tennessee's got to play Alabama. They play Kentucky, Mississippi State.
And here is Galen Hall coming off the field, being surrounded by photographers, cameramen, and also by radio people who are ready to do interviews. And I'm sure he's
very exciting
happy.
Game. Fourth quarter, our defense, they gave him the one drive, and then they rose up and stopped him again. So very good game.
There he is, shaking hands with Tony Robinson.
And I think Tony's a great athlete, a great quarterback. He showed he's a very good quarterback.
Neil Anderson carried the ball, must have been 100 times it seemed like.
And then Neil is that type of player. He's that valuable to us, and he played an excellent game.
Yeah, three-game SLC win streak, and how do you feel about the team after 5 games?
They're very good about our team right now. I think we're playing together as units, offense, defense, and kicking game, and we're becoming a pretty good football team.
Thank you.
So there's Galen Hall with the score, Florida 17, Tennessee 10. We'll be back at Florida Field after these messages. Back at Florida Field as the Gators defeat Tennessee by a score of 17-10 this afternoon to go 4-0-1 on the season and 3-0 in the Southeastern Conference.
I was going to mention that Tennessee has a big battle with Alabama coming up. After that, Kentucky will be the toughest conference opponent for them. They were hoping to win today and give themselves a better shot at that SEC title. Tennessee has a fine team. They have a very, very good team. That's why you have to give even more credit to the University of Florida, because they beat an outstanding Tennessee team here. Tennessee was in the game to the very end. The Gator defense did the job when they had to, and that Gator offense with Neil Anderson carrying the football just chewed that clock and yardage up.
Next week, the Raging Cajuns of southwestern Louisiana, right here at Florida Field in Gainesville, and we'll be bringing you the action over the station which you're watching right now, or the cable system that you're watching, and we appreciate your being with us. We'd like to thank Robert Salon, Dick Crago, Joe Bonikowski, our spotters today, a sports information office at Tennessee, and John Humanick, Norm Carlson, Chris Cameron, and the sports information office here at the University of Florida. Mid-State Federal player of the game, Neil Anderson, and what a great career he had in 84 against Tennessee, 178 yards, and this year, 160. So they took 18 yards away from him this
year. I think Johnny Majors is going to give Neil Anderson a graduation present. What do you think?
I'm sure he is. And the Alligator along the sideline talking to some friendly Gator fans. It's just been a great afternoon for football, a warm, warm afternoon. Over 74,000 people here for this great game. Be sure and join us next week for Southwest Louisiana. And now for all the crew and for Jim Yarbrough, I'm Jim Gallagher. Thanks for being with us. Good day, Florida Field.
Football has been brought to you by Atlantic Bank, by Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Florida, by the Florida Citrus Growers, also by Dairy Farmers Incorporated, by Farm Credit Service of Florida, by your Florida and South Georgia Ford dealers, by Gatorade Thirst Quencher, by Gator Bait, by Likes Meats, also by Scotty's, by Sonny's Real Pit Barbecue, and by Whirlpool. We'll be right back.